What's up, everybody? We're going to start in a little bit. We're going to have a very serious investigation into potentially paranormal happenings in the Burnell household. Feel free to answer the poll. Who is messing with our guy, Phil? Is it answer A, a ghoul? Is it answer B, a demon? Is it perhaps answer C, a vampire? Or is it answer D, crippling paranoia? All right, sounds good. We're about to start the stream in a couple of minutes. Let me just get all my stuff in check. And you listen to this song.
Of course, bounties are for fun, little girl. Again, I can't make anyone do anything. This is not a commitment. There's no legal contract. These are people saying they're going to do something nice, right? So if you say you're going to do something nice, then do it. And if you don't, you're banned.
Rob, you owe me easy money, right? 10, 20, 40, duh. Easy money.
Motherfucker.
10, 20, 40.
Here's
easy money. $10 top 10. $20 top 5. Got the bag, got the bag, got the bag. Correct? I have your super chat right here. That's 40 bucks. And if you don't pay up, I'm gonna open the door and shoot you. You owe me easy money, right? 10, 20, 40. Correct? Easy money. 10, 20, 40.
How do I make this work, dude? Somebody recommended me use Brave browser yesterday, and I started to, but now when sound is playing in one tab, it's gonna get muted when another tab is open. Anyways, let's just start. What's with the music? Let's get into this, because it's super, super important, super deep, extremely dangerous things are happening in the House of Burnell, also known as the Snort Fort. Now, yesterday, there was a mystery issue surrounding his internet, apparently, that made him quit the first stream, but then come back for the late stream. It was kind of weird. So let's see what clips we got, courtesy of course, the hardest working Twitter account, Poems Future. Welcome, chat. We're going to be watching the pre-stream today, and then probably nothing else. Because, I mean, come on. We're just going to do the super bare minimum today. Let's just see if the guy has gone live. So I can put him here on the side. All right. Yes, he is. Wow, he was complaining about being super stressed out in his chat earlier. So we will have to put up with that shit and complaining. So we got internet issues again. Throw streams into disarray. And he was crying about, you know, missing out on money from the first stream that he had to quit because he was like down 2 hours worth of gameplay, guys. That's serious. We're not like bullshitting here. So let's see this, I guess the daily wrap thing. If anything is supposed to recap this, I guess the DSP is supposed to. So let's take a look at this shit.
So, final thing, because I know you guys are going to say, well, if it happened all day today, what's to stop it tomorrow? I took matters into my own hands.
That's what I was gonna say.
I took matters into my own hands, and it should not happen tomorrow. If it does happen tomorrow, I will be absolutely shocked. Like, my jaw will go, oh, because I was told that what, you know, the actions that I took will fix it. That's what I was told.
I was told.
So you would think.
So he sat on customer support for an hour again. Is that what he did? I don't know. Apparently, the issues are with his internet, but he claims somebody is messing with him. So he implies that somebody is, you know, messing with him on purpose to disrupt his stream. Which to me is just all paranoia, because he's been having issues with Comcast for months, since like the summer.
It will. So I guess we'll see what happens, okay?
But, and he has taken measures. He said it like he's going to shoot somebody or something. He's taking things into his own hands now. He's putting his foot down.
Hopefully tomorrow, no nonsense, and hopefully moving forward, no nonsense. I can't tell you any more than that until the story's over. When the story's over, you're going to love the story that I have to tell you.
Oh, and it's going to be a real good story.
No drama. No nonsense. Everyone relax. Tomorrow should be a normal day of content. Fingers crossed, but I'm feeling positive about it. I'm feeling like we'll be back to normal. Please watch tonight's videos, which I'm about to upload right now. Please, if you can, support tomorrow's streams because I literally just got screwed over by malicious bullshit.
Uh-oh.
By internet.
Okay, so malicious bullshit. Directly, we can just at this point just say that he's claiming that somebody is messing with him. It's not just another Comcast thing. It's just somebody is trolling him in particular. Fuck DSP in particular is what that guy is saying. So I'm pretty interested in how that's going to turn out. Of course, absolutely zero hopes up or expectations because it's DSP. Like you can ask him what time it is and still get underwhelmed by the answer. So. Don't think it's going to be something too interesting. Somebody just told him how to reset his router or something, and he thought he was building a fucking rocket or something. What is this one? This is just another beg. Let's catch up on the begs, because he was begging like fucking crazy yesterday. He was begging like they were going to take away his ability to speak. I don't know why this browser is so slow, dude. That's why I use Edge. And
so, guys, I'm playing for about another 45 minutes to an hour. It really depends. I want to go a little later tonight because I didn't get enough gameplay in earlier because of the fucking bullshit internet issues. So I will.
Another day in the vortex with everyone's non-gay way boyfriend. Last night, the guy begged 5 times in under 1 hour. But he doesn't do it every 5 minutes.
Well, it's not every 5 minutes. If it was, then it would be a much bigger number. Of course, it's not every 5 minutes, literally. So you're misrepresenting him to make him look bad, you fucking idiot. Why would you do something like that? He's just trying to chill and have fun and make a living. Why are you such an asshole?
We'll try to go a little later tonight. But again, it would be appreciated if you could support the stream. You can see.
Yeah. I love the background sounds as well. It's like we're dropping into like Call of Duty Warzone and the dude is just begging over voice chat. Shit is crazy.
2 hours. So if you like the content or if you just want to help out and support right now because of the bullshit earlier, I would appreciate it. Right now it's been pretty fucking dead, so it kind of sucks.
It does kind of suck. What else we got? So at what point... Yeah, this is just more begging, and this is the internet working type of thing. This was a great moment. I've seen this clip before. And of course, we have a quote. I'm trying to make up for the fact that I missed half my stream earlier. There we go. And he actually didn't miss half his stream. I think it was just the last hour. But that's all I saw. I haven't actually been watching it. But he did look very rattled when it happened. I wonder if I can actually find the clip of it, because he was like, oh, you guys, something happened. Oh, yeah, it's this one. Shout out to Phil Callens at King of Gout 1 for the clip. This is a very good clip, because he looked freaked out.
All right, guys, well, basically...
My heart can't take another grocery bag theft incident.
Oh, I pray to God it's not another grocery bag being stolen, because, man... We have a worldwide shortage of reusable plastic grocery bags, so I don't know what he's going to do if he gets another one stolen.
Messing with me, and what I have to do is I have to look into it, so I...
Hold on.
Alright, guys, well, basically, someone's messing with me, and what I have to do is I have to look into it, so I can't stream right now. I have to get out of here. I got two tips, alright? I did get a 222 tip.
Alright, as you can see, it's kind of like when he came back on Halloween, wearing that nice dress shirt, and he was crapping on Tevin. That's kind of how it seems like. He seems like genuinely tilted. So I don't think it's something that he's making up, but it might be his paranoia making him like blow it out of proportion. Because I'm thinking it's just like Comcast issues, because the dude got Comcast issues every 2 weeks or something. They seem to be having some kind of a problem. What is this one? Let's see this random clip.
10 to 15 minute videos on YouTube with ads all over them.
Oh no. This is, no, we're talking about back in the day. By the way, Line app had a huge, what was it called? Security and data breach. So one of these days, we might find something on our boy, Mr. Bernelski. Yeah, what they claim is Line app owner flags huge data breach, although no bank information revealed. All we need is the phone number, not any kind of bank account stuff. We already got that one. We already got that. And, yeah, oh, some dudes talked about him. So these two guys that are apparently, like, kind of decent size. I don't know how many people watch them, but they talked about Phil. So right, he, no, see this one.
Open me up to the Lol Cow podcast, and I've been hooked.
Look, I'm not one to endorse stuff made by Keemstar, yeah. But there's two things he's done great. The old Fortnite Friday tournaments, those were amazing, where he just got creators and he'd Friday Fortnite tournaments until Epic stomped his ass out and created their own tournament. That's basically what happened. True lore, by the way. And the second thing he's done great is the Lolcow podcast.
Wings of Redemption, the other guy that I've never heard of, and Buggy.
I don't know the middle guy. He's kind of irrelevant. He's just a middleman that's kind of there to keep things ticking on.
It was almost DSP. And if you don't know DSP, do your research. Look up PlayStation stream loading. Enjoy. You're welcome.
Look, should we just show them?
If Wildcat is ever mad at you, all I need to do is show him this gif, and I always make him giggle.
Okay, here we go.
All right, guys. I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm frustrated for two reasons. Reason one.
And you know what clip they're gonna pull up? The vintage, the classic, the scorn begging segment.
Yeah, the game does suck. I really did not like tonight's stream. And in addition to that, as you guys can see, I stayed extra late for you guys, and basically it amounted to nothing. No one's really supported, which pisses me off. It does. Yeah, I'm playing a game. Obviously, it's frustrating. A lot of people showed up to watch it.
Complaining to all the broke boys.
Yeah, the broke boys, you know? Basically, he's the 45-year-old Pokemon, male version.
Excuse me, he is 41 going on 42. You're factually wrong. Therefore, everything you said holds absolutely no value, okay?
Which sets me.
Sound good.
I'm going to hope that tomorrow when I finish it, there will be some support.
And the funny thing about him is that he spent, I think, $40,000 on...
No, more. More. On a mobile game?
Yeah.
On a, it was more. I thought it was around $75,000.
On a...
That's still too low.
Mobile game.
He's wasted a huge amount of money. He begs for donations and stuff like that. Tries to manipulate people. But let's get the juice. Come on.
This is how I introduced Brian to DSP, guys.
Did you introduce me to DSP?
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
I did.
So let's say this guy thinks the webcam is off and he's starting his stream. He's got a 5
yeah time. And then we got this. Meanwhile, Turkey Tom, the best Turkish YouTuber, responded to Dark Side Phil in another 35 minute video. God damn. Clearly I'm not gonna have time to watch this now, but I'm probably gonna listen through it later, so you can go check it out on the Tom Dark channel, the darkest channel on YouTube. Just make sure to turn the lights on. The comments are nice. Thank you for once again providing the fuel to yet another self-aggrandizing rant from DSP. Well, we know what to expect today, if not anything else. With the money DSP would have made off of being on that podcast, he clearly could have brought so many sweaty wrestler PNGs. And that's clearly the truth. Good for you to wash your hands of DSP. You made a great documentary and you've been handling Phil's nonsense with pure class. He'll keep crying about you for months because he always tries to paint himself as the victim. Of course we did. Oh, and we got a new title for his stream. Thanks for the update. Let's see what it is. Let's do a title reveal segment. And the title is, whoa, emergency! Emergency stream! I can't work and I need to talk about it now. Guys, we're in emergency mode. I'm gonna play my intro. Oh no! Help! Light the fires, wave the banners. We are officially in a state of emergency in the United States of Phil. We are officially going through a tough time. It's a state of emergency. I declare martial law. This is not a normal stream by any means, is what Phil says in chat. This is about to be an instant classic, you guys. I'm happy I decided to turn up the stream. Even though most of you voted for no, when I asked you on Twitter, is DSP going to reveal the mystery condition? So yeah. Green Lobster, listening to this on speakers at work is absolutely your responsibility. You know you shouldn't be. You know I play risque content. This is an edgy stream.
Fuck all you! Fuck all you! Fuck all you! Fuck all you hoes!
I hope your boss heard that one. Let's wait for him to come, I guess. So yeah, this is now an emergency state. Let's see what else you got. Maybe we can watch the whole daily rap from yesterday, or at least a section of it that is... Yeah, look at this! Comcast Xfinity! He changed the thumbnail too! Super drama stream! We love it! We're back! It's officially the season! It is the season of the drama. Let's see, the daily wrap. Internet issues again! Oh, he's here, hold on. There we go. What is happening? It's just an empty chair type of vibe. What a fucking bum. And we got the what the fuck song in the background.
Motherfucker! Talk and all that.
Suck a dog off. Suck a dog off.
You
BEGCON Black. BEGCON Black. All dance to stations.
BEGCON Zero. Everybody, take your designated spot in the bunker.
Holy shit! Where'd you find this? Datpiff.com.
What's that?
You hoes.
Detroit till I die, motherfucker.
Fuck all you hoes! Detroit till I die, motherfucker!
Alright. However, let's remind ourselves. We're talking about Darkseid Phil here. So this is bound to be underwhelming in some way. So don't get hyped up by the great title or by the great thumbnail. This might just be a nothing burger. But the title is really cute, I can't lie. Emergency, all caps. I can't work, and I need to talk about it now. Fucking good. But it would be nice if he showed up, though, instead of whatever the fuck this is. Yeah, I'm gonna take a screenshot of the title just for history's sake. What the fuck is this song, by the way? He's a fucking ass. Yeah, the thumbnail, we got Comcast, Xfinity. Everything is shaping to be a classic disaster stream. Let's see if we got a black shirt or not. Let's run a super quick poll that will only last until he actually appears on camera. All right, let's do the quick poll. You got three options. You got the dress shirt and jammies combo, which is underrated combo. I think it gives him plus 50 professionalism. But I think today he needs plus 60 sympathy points. So for sympathy points, I would say a black shirt is best for an emergency video. Because when you wear the black shirt, you don't distract people with anything else, you know? You don't distract them with a pattern or a logo or anything going on. So they can focus on what you are saying. And what you are saying is that you need their money. So whenever you're in a situation like this, you want to be dressed as simple as possible. You want to be relatable, right? You're not going to be decked out in like chains and like Rolexes with like all your fingers covered in rings. You got to be simple, you know, back to basics. Keep it simple. Yeah, we got to be pity maxing. That's what we need. We need pity maxing today. Put all your skill points in pity. Put a little bit in delusion and paranoia, because they help you pass some skill checks that you have with yourself. So it's really good to be deluded when a difficult skill check comes up. Also, if we get a combat segment, he's probably going to be screwed, because he didn't put any of his points in combat. You know, hand-to-hand, range combat, spraying Jasper in the face. So you really never know, man. I'm really looking forward to what build he's going to come through with today, because it's a special stream. Super special emergency. Do we have a community post? Let's see if we drop the community post while he's dropping a doo-doo in the bathroom. Oh yeah, of course we do. Well, I didn't want to do this, but I guess I have to. I'll tell you all that's going on with my internet for years. Years. And you won't believe it. Chances are my internet won't stay on, but I'm also recording. And he tagged Comcast Business and Xfinity Support, because he copy-pasted this shit from Twitter. Because these motherfuckers don't have a YouTube account, I assume, or at least just Comcast do, but they don't appear as tagged. So it's just a copy-pasted tweet, man. This dude fucking stinks. So it's Comcast's fault. Nobody's actually fucking with him. It's just his internet goes off because he has shitty internet. And also overpriced. So I guess he's getting scammed on many, many levels. You won't believe it. Let's see what happened. He called the support help desk. He told them his internet was going off. They asked him to restart the modem. He did it. It didn't get fixed. He sat in a support call with a bot for another 35 minutes. They told him that they're sorry and that they agree with all his criticisms and that they're really sorry, but there's nothing they can do. And then he hung up the phone or closed the tab in his browser and called them slurs. That's basically what my prediction is. Yeah, it is also possible that there's just a drop in service in the Seattle area or something like that. I don't know about that. I haven't looked it up. Because, I mean, who fucking cares about DSP's internet? But what we're going to get is the actual result from this is what's going to be entertaining. Because the result is he missed X amount of streams or X amount of man hours, or let's say begging hours. And now he needs to make up that money. So that's going to be the entertaining part in the next few days. Because remember, he is still making the money back from when he was sick like a month ago. So we're in a double making up money combo situation. In which I guess he gets a boost to his begging stats. Maybe some of the sympathy and like pity. And maybe a little bit to the paranoia. And yeah, oh yeah, you bet. This is going to be the whole of December. He's going to be remembering, he's going to be reminding you of this, that it happened. And of course, December is known as the season of giving. So hint, hint, you know what to do. Open up that pesky PayPal. Send a charitable contribution. Tell him how sorry you are that he lost all this revenue, all this phantom revenue. Oh, man, what, where the fuck is he? Let's see, let's scroll back in chat. No, he's been gone. I'm going to be recording this anyways, the last thing he saw. I have to show you guys stuff to prove what I'm going to tell you. Yo, we got a proof segment. Oh man, we got only so few proof segments of all time. This is gonna be hype. But also at the same time, it's a disclaimer for me to tell you, don't be hyped about this. Because if you've seen him cry about not having internet before, it's probably going to be 90% of this and 5% showing proof. But I wonder if he's going to claim it's the company's fault or somebody actually messing with him. Okay, he's live.
Set up here. And then we're in, and this is not a normal stream by any means whatsoever. This is not what I want to do today. This is not what I intend to do today. I hope that we can at some point do normal content today, because you know me, I'm not about drama, I'm not about bullshit, but it seems like at this point,
you know me, I'm not about drama, sadly, dude,
this seems to be my only avenue of what I can do. I don't want to do what I'm about to do,
but I thought you took things in your own hands.
I have to, because at this point it seems like I'm not getting helped by anyone. And if this is what I have to do to try to get help...
Oh, he's going to put him on blast.
So be it. I don't know what else I'm supposed to do, quite frankly. And I think that when many people hear this situation, they're going to be shocked and startled and be like, what the fuck? And it's going to freak them out as much as this whole thing has freaked me out. Because it's not funny at all.
Well, they're going to get freaked out too. Wow.
Quite frankly, it's...
No, it's not divorce. Stop saying divorce. All right. You assholes. It's clearly an internet issue.
Let me go ahead and finish my setup here.
All right.
And
I thought that's what you were doing this whole time.
Now, I'm just going to forewarn all of you, because there's going to be different people joining the stream over the day, I'm sure. I'm just going to forewarn all of you that likely the internet is going to go down when I'm doing this broadcast, and there's nothing I can do about it, apparently.
They don't want you to hear this broadcast.
Just stick around.
Broadcast is going to be terminated.
It comes right back, but then it's going to go off and come back and go off and come back or whatever. And there's, you know, again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be recording the entire time, and I'm going to upload this so that you will actually get an uninterrupted feed and exploration of it as well. Okay? So, just so you know, okay? Because, yeah, I know a lot of people are going to probably not tune in because I said, oh, it's not this regular stream, it's an emergency stream. So you just know a ton of people are now going to tune in. And what's going to happen is my internet's going to keep going off, right? Of course. So, anyway, I'm going to get started in a minute. I have absolutely no idea what we're doing today. Once I explain the situation, maybe it'll make more sense, and then...
All right. No black shirt. You know, you guys lost.
But right now, there's really no way to negate what's happening. But you'll see what... You'll understand once I explain, okay?
I really hope so. All
right. So we're going to get started in a moment. All right? This is no bullshit. Now, here's the thing. If you guys go ahead and, you know, contribute.
Oh, he is super freaked out, dude. Look at how fucking rattled he is.
Do a normal stream like I normally would. Right now, I'm supposed to be doing the podcast.
He's in tweak mode, 150%.
And I can't do that. Okay? I can't. So, I need to explain to you what's going on so you understand. And hopefully, this stream and or video will spurn someone to do something. Let's put it that way. It'll convince someone to move their ass and do something about this at this rate, okay? So we'll see. We'll see what happens, okay? But, you know, I wish I could do my normal content today. It's obvious I can't. As you know, I already...
He needs help, you guys.
Twice.
So he's going to basically put Comcast on blast.
Stream. I was just setting it up, and it went down.
That's what's going to happen.
As you know, at any moment's notice, this stream could go down, and I'm going to start, like I said, I'll start recording, so that way it'll continue to be a video.
You can die at any point, you guys.
Goes down or whatever.
At any point, it might happen.
Okay. Sound good? There's no way I could tell you everything before it goes down. Like, it's a story I have to tell you, because it's actually a pretty fucked up situation that I'm finally aware of, and now have the evidence to say this. I know what's happening, but it's a really fucked up situation that needs to be resolved immediately, but I'm not getting immediate help.
So that's why I have to explain to you guys, because I can't even work. It'd be one thing if it's something you can ignore. How can I ignore it when I can't work, right? If I can't stream and I'm a full-time live streamer, I can't do my job. So I can't make money. I can't pay my bills. So obviously,
bills are in danger.
Urgency. I can't do anything else.
Bombcast, wake up.
Playing a game, my stream will just keep going down anyway, right? All right. So are we good? And by the way, I fully know that this is absolutely going to get clipped and shared all over the internet. When you hear this story, you're going to be like, what the fuck? Okay? You are. You're going to be like, what the fuck? Like, no way. Because it's that
crazy.
Whoa,
this is Phil's viral story, you guys. Let's get to see it. I'm so excited. The most viral story of all time. They're going to make a documentary based on it.
If everyone starts talking about this publicly, then maybe I'll get some help.
Oh, wow.
I mean, I think that's what it's going to come down to is...
This is gonna be the dumbest shit you've ever heard, dude. This is gonna be so stupid.
And it seems like this is gonna
be. I'm already becoming stupider listening to this.
Because I've went through all of the normal avenues you're supposed to go through to get help, and no one's helping me at all. Okay? Huh, okay.
All right, let's go. Let's roll.
All right, so when should I start?
And action.
A ton of people are joining. Not surprising. There's probably more and more people who are gonna be joining here.
Okay, first stake.
I want you to understand, for those who contribute, I absolutely will do shout-outs. I just have to do it at appropriate times. So if anything comes in, you will get a normal shout-out, and I would appreciate that because I can't do my normal content today. I couldn't have a normal day yesterday because of what's going on.
He seems to be dropping frames because he's choppy as fuck.
You're going to see what kind of help I need.
I'm not chopping up. I'm at 0%.
Okay?
All right. Action. Okay. And action. And action.
All okay. Right. Shall we begin now?
Yeah,
with
please.
Over 700 viewers and climbing.
Oh, yeah.
A lot more.
He loves that shit. That's what he's looking at.
Probably going to be a lot more. Because this is so weird. You know, how often do I do something like this?
Pretty often compared to everybody else. Oh, he's waiting for more views.
Thank you,
yeah.
Jason J. For I appreciate that.
Let's see how many we can get until he actually gets into the story. Oh, and how many times he's going to start from the beginning for all the people that just joined in. Because people are late to class. They didn't know it was going to be a special class today. An emergency class with Mr. Burnell. Yo, he's legitimately just waiting for the views to go up. Legitimately. That's all that is happening right now.
Okay, I've had enough of this idiot. You're out of here for.
Oh, okay. He's also banning people. Who did he ban? Ah, shit. I don't have Hyper Chat right now, so I can't see it. Well, somebody's going to screenshot it anyways.
Okay.
Yo, can we get into it?
Start? All right. I'm just going to preface this again as I'm about to begin, because I will begin now. The internet likely will go down and I won't be able to tell the whole story. You won't hear it, but I'm going to be recording this. So if you're listening and all of a sudden it goes down and it comes back and it goes down and it comes back and it goes down and it comes back, which it likely will, I'm recording and I will upload this after so that way you can hear the whole story in its entirety.
Bro, how many times are you going to say this?
People will share the story so that people know what's
going on. Yeah, we got it. Your internet is bad.
And that basically this will be handled, okay? All right, are we ready to start?
Yeah.
Okay.
And action.
All right, here we go. Hello, my name is Phil Burnell, more commonly known as DSP or Darkside Phil on the internet, and I run a YouTube channel called DSP Gaming. It's been my job.
This is a manifesto video.
At this point,
he's about to blow up Comcast offices.
Creator and live streamer. Although. I am a long time.
He sent them a care package already.
Sadly, there is a malicious community of people that follow me around the internet who don't like me.
What?
And they've done things over the years to hurt me and my family because they don't like me for various reasons. But that's not why we're here today. I am broadcasting a special stream and recording this for YouTube as a way to document what is going on in my life right now and as a cry for help because I need help right now with this situation.
What?
And it seems like absolutely no one is willing to help. So allow me to explain what's going on because, to be clear, I don't like drama. I didn't want to make this video. I'm supposed to be doing my standard broadcast. See, here's my setup. I'm supposed to be doing a podcast, playing a video game, and I'm not unable to do that because my internet has been compromised and keeps getting interrupted or reset. Okay? So allow me to tell you a story, because I need to tell you the background story in order for this to make sense.
Oh, first we need the context.
My internet likely will go down while I tell this story, and if it does, I am recording this locally and
I guess he's expecting people from Comcast to actually watch this video.
I'm aware of what's really going on in its full.
It's going to be like a 3-hour video.
Okay. My tale I'm about to tell you is going to sound very creepy, and it's going to sound very weird, but it's very true, and I have evidence to back it up. Okay? So,
I want to see that evidence.
Years, as I have been a live streamer, you know, here on YouTube, as I said, there's certain people who don't like me for various different reasons, and we're not here to discuss that. What we're here to discuss is what I've been through. Because over the years, on and off, I have had internet issues. My internet all of a sudden resetting and going down out of nowhere. Things being messed up in my modem. And there's been multiple times over the years where I've had to involve my ISP, who is Comcast. Now, Comcast is the parent company. They have divisions. Xfinity is the division that is for residential service, but I have two business line internets in my home, okay? So I deal with the Comcast business portion of them. I don't deal with anything Xfinity whatsoever. So if I have a problem, I have to call Comcast business customer support and go through that process, all right? Now, they're a little different. They have 24/7 support, but if you call after hours, you end up talking with someone who's across the globe, who doesn't have the same access and or power to do things as if you called during business hours. So technically, even though they have 24/7 support, if you call after normal like office hours, they can't help you with anything. Okay? They just, okay, well, tomorrow something will happen, right? So anyway, there's been many times in the 9.5 years now that I've had Comcast business where something's going on with my internet and we can't figure out what the deal is. Is there something in the lines? Is there some malicious activity going on? You know, most of the time what ends up happening is a tech comes out to the house. They look at the modem. They look at everything. They can't really figure anything out. A lot of the times we just do like a hard modem swap and it fixes the issue. Or we think it does. Okay? I have not had any consistent internet issues in a while. So...
Oops. Seems like he's having one right now. Hopefully that's his issue, not mine. Turn down the quality a little bit. Oh, did they actually get him? Dude, they actually silenced him. Come on, please be back, dude. What is... Oh, yeah, his chat is dead too. Look at this. Everybody died in his chat. Look at this. Oh, no. What a great moment. Oh, and he's back. Okay, but we missed the story.
Is maliciously doing this to me over and over. Okay,
but we right now, we missed the story.
Talking with
dipshit.
The internet just reset.
We'll need to watch the director's cut.
Back, but it's gonna keep doing that. Watch.
What a fucking
going
asshole.
Out, back, going out, coming back over the course of the stream, as I told you it would. All right. So for those live, you're coming back. This is gonna happen multiple times probably during this stream. There's nothing you can do about it. If it happens, just deal with it. It should come back within a minute or two. Okay. Okay? All right, but I'm recording locally, so I'll keep going now. All right? So, here's what's going on, and here is basically how all of this came to light in the last 30 days or so. Okay? So, it's kind of weird because every once in a while, all right, every once in a while, something very weird will happen at a very important time. Right? I'll be in the middle of something very, very important. Like, I'm on a podcast that's super important. Or, you know, I'm in the middle of a great big marathon and there's important stuff going on. And all of a sudden, my internet will go out. And everyone's looking at it like, what? Well, isn't it weird that Phil's internet always works until there's like a really important thing going on. And then all of a sudden, it doesn't work.
No, right? Not really.
Like, what's going on with that? So it's weird because everyone's, you know, saying, is it paranoia or is it just that?
Yeah, it is paranoia. You
know, it's bad luck. Like, what?
But now he's going to prove it.
On, right? Don't know. We don't know what's going on.
Hopefully.
What's causing it? All right. So, if you guys remember, a little over a month ago, I want to say it was October 26, 2023, because by the way, today is November 28th, 2023, just to document the date and here.
this is already a terrible video. Nobody's watching this.
Internet kept going out during a live stream, and no one could, like, what is going on? Why does it keep happening? There's one thing if there's a blip in the line, because when there's
a blip in the line, and a noise in the line,
like, oh, you're in the green now, you're yellow now,
you're yellow, you're changing races,
going like this, right? But in this case, all right, the internet just goes flat out, dead, signal drops, then has to reconnect, then signal drops, then has to reconnect. So this has happened to me before, and I'm thinking it's a DDoS attack, meaning, or DDoS attack, meaning someone somehow has gotten my IP address, and they're sending...
I have your IP, Phil.
...to knock me off the internet. But the weird thing about
I'll give it back to you for $1,000.
You can see that in your modem or router settings. Like, you can go inside of your modem or router, and you can actually look at settings, and you can see, you know, like, oh, packets of data hit the firewall or whatever.
So you can tell when there's a massive explosion.
And there's no evidence of that, all right? So that whole day, I was trying to figure this out. We couldn't figure it out. And I was like, I don't know if I'm going to be able to work or whatever. This really sucks. So if you remember, the next day was my day off. It was a Thursday. But then Friday, I had a Comcast Business Tech come out here. What happened was that afternoon, I called Comcast Business. I explained the situation to them. And of course, they say, well, we don't know what's going on. We can't tell from our end. I mean, no kidding, right? All they can do is remotely test your modem. You know, run a few tests. If you wonder what I'm doing, I'm decompressing my back.
He's decompressing his back for the video that's supposed to be for Comcast.
Really the ability to
because he introduced himself, you know, like first name, last name. You know, decompressing. This dude is a fucking meme, dude.
Very intelligent, very nice people, and they do their absolute best to help you out the most they can when they're at your home. Okay? So, they sent out a tech that Friday to my house, all right, in order to look at what was going on with my internet. So this would have been like October 28th or something like that, okay? And you guys know, because I was on the stream and I said, okay, when the tech's here, I'm gonna go offline or whatever. So the tech showed up, ran, you know, testing everything, trying to figure everything out. He's like, there's nothing wrong with the lines. There is nothing wrong with your modem. He says, so let's go into the modem and look at settings and things. And he goes in there and he's like, what, you know, what is all this? Like, do you know what any of this stuff is? And I'm like, I don't know what this stuff is. All right. So what I would like to do, so to show you
the this is gonna be crazy. Let's see what the fuck this is.
This is what he finds.
Let me just increase the quality
of my modem. You ready? Ready? Now I don't know how big this is gonna be. I'm probably gonna have to blow it up.
It's gonna blow it up.
Okay.
What? What is this, bro?
So the bottom is just, it shows what devices are connected locally. There's no information.
Oh, he's giving away his MAC address.
You should look at. Is the information at the
he
top.
Gave away his MAC address to the
someone
Xbox and other
into
shit
my modem, all right, and actually set up content block content filtering, all right, in order to prevent
and they got PayPal on it
to go on certain websites.
They want to get him banned from PayPal.
Blocked certain words inside of my modem, all right. So they wanted to prevent me from going to YouTube.
And they blocked the word Phil.
Twitter. They wanted
they blocked the word Phil.
And they wanted to block the words Twitter, Phil, and DSP Gaming. So
Phil.
I have no access at all to that content. All right? So, I mean, of course this was confusing. Here I'm thinking my internet's going down. It's not. Someone actually went into my modem.
Bro, I am in tears.
The settings, unbeknownst to me, without my permission, to filter content.
Total troll victory. He got absolutely humbled.
Because you got to wonder, who has access to the modem? Well, when you think about it, who would? Me? Or my ISP, Comcast?
Uh-oh.
That's it. There's literally no other way that you can get into that modem.
Right. The Comcast guy was a detractor, dude.
You could argue, well, maybe you've had that modem for so long, someone got the information. No, I've swapped modems multiple times and everything, right? No. And so I went ahead with that Comcast tech and we looked at the logs. And in the logs, it says right in the logs of that modem, it is a Comcast employee.
Yo!
That logged into the modem and made those changes.
Look at this.
It says it right there. It doesn't say customer login or anything. It says their own rep login.
Yo!
They did it.
Okay. A literal Comcast detractor. Literally. That's fucking wild. We got a man on the inside, so, you guys. Do you realize the possibility?
You know, plain as day. We have evidence.
Let's fucking go.
This is happening, that someone at Comcast, someone who is employed by that company, my ISP, has access to my modem and is going into my modem and changing settings and doing things. Okay? So this was October 28th, okay, that this happened. And basically, I, you know, the tech that was here was dumbfounded. He's like, dude, I've never seen anything like this before. Obviously, this is crazy. He called his manager, who's the regional tech manager out here in Washington or whatever, told him the whole story. He, of course, was dumbfounded, had never heard anything like this. He says, so here's what we're going to do. He says, there's two things that can be done. He says, number one, we're going to obviously launch an investigation into this, okay? And we'll let you know, you know, you're going to, you should get a call or whatever, or, you know, they, he even gave me the regional manager's number and said, you can call the regional manager as a follow-up, you know, if you're not hearing anything concrete from us, as you know, to say what's going on, we'll let you know, okay? So this was October 28th, I was told this. Now, the other thing that you can do, if you absolutely, are in a situation here where, you know, it keeps happening, you can go buy your own modem. Like, you can go buy a cable modem that's not ours.
He's dropping frames like crazy again.
Comcast, then it's your own property. They can't
lock it. He's super chopped and screwed right now.
They can't do anything to it because it's not our modem. So you have the option to do that. And I'm like, yeah, but is it really fair that I should have to go out and spend hundreds of dollars to buy my own cable modem?
Hundreds of dollars?
Okay.
Hundreds of dollars.
Right?
Perhaps so, even millions of hundreds.
By the way, I'm going to... Can I disable ads on this fucking thing?
Oh, he doesn't want ads to interrupt his manifesto video. Because this is a video he expects Comcast to watch.
I'm going to disable it because it's more important to me that you guys hear the story than ads run on this.
He's literally recording this just so Comcast can see it and do something about it. And he thinks this story is going to go super viral.
I appreciate that. But obviously, this is an important story. This is just the beginning of the story. This is just the very
welcome, everybody, from WPIG. You guys missed a super banger of a first part. So rewind
so
the stream.
This tech leaves my house. And I start to think to myself, wait a minute.
What somebody hacked his modem legitimately. And they work for Comcast, allegedly.
When all of a sudden my internet would go out when I was in the middle of something important. And it dawned on me. The Side Scrollers podcast.
What?
I was on that podcast in March.
Is he accusing him of leaking his IP?
Exactly the same way that it was going out then. It just went off for a minute or two and then came back. And that was when all that crap went down on the Side Scrollers podcast, if you remember.
What?
Remember that?
What crap?
I came back and all of a sudden now Keemstar's on the show.
Wait.
And drama and all the shit's going on.
How paranoid is he?
And I'm thinking to myself, that's exactly what happened. This is some kind of a malicious person at Comcast who works for the company, who doesn't like me, and actually has been striking down my internet and fucking with my business over the years whenever they felt like it because they thought it either was funny or it would hurt me or whatever.
Oh, you fucking bum.
Okay?
He is so crazy.
Basically, it's now dawning on me. I'm like, I can't believe this. All right? But this is absolutely true. What's going on? This must be it. What else could it be? How is it that every time that something important is going on, my internet goes out, right?
Yo, again?
So.
Oh, yeah, that was just a little bit.
Now, this was October 28th, okay?
It was just a little bit of a strike.
Since October 28th, I had no internet issues. And I'm thinking, gee, maybe this person wised up and realized, oh, well, if I keep doing this, I'm gonna get caught.
This is the choppiest stream in the galaxy, dude.
You can see a login from an employee to says they logged into the
Oops. Where'd you go, Phil?
Evidence. Oh, no,
he's here.
Okay, so basically, I'm thinking, you know, maybe this person wise up and they're gonna try to cover their tracks. They're gonna try to make it so that
this is the best DSP stream, dude.
They don't wanna make sure that
this is the hypest stream.
Fired, or I mean, let's be honest, be arrested. Because this is malicious. This isn't.
Let me just lower the quality a little bit. Because, like, this is not normal.
That's happening, right? So, nothing's been going on for the last month. But what happened in the last month? I got really sick. I got a really bad cold, flu. It might have even been COVID. So for like over a week, I was knocked out. So I didn't follow up on any of this going on because I was too sick. By the time I came back, I was trying to play catch up and everything with the business. So, you know, to be honest, did I forget about it? No. But I was so already wrapped up in everything else. And by the way, my internet was going fine, no problems. So I'm thinking in my head, all right, so it's not a big deal then. I'll just, you know, maybe they took care of it.
The weird pop-ups that come up during this segment, terrible. Should have turned off the animations.
They got this guy, and they kicked him out of the company, and it's all said and done, it's fine, right? So maybe that's the case, and maybe we're all good now, right?
Oops, I guess we're not good. We're buffering again. Do we have F's in the chat? Nope, not yet.
No, that's not what happened.
What happened?
Okay, because now I'm going to tell you something way worse.
Uh-oh.
All right, then everything else that just happened. All right, so get ready for this. So it's Wednesday, my
Let's
day
go.
Off last week.
It's going to be wild.
The day before American Thanksgiving. So that would have been what? Like November 22nd, I think? So it's November 22nd. It's my day off. And all of a sudden, right in the middle of the day, all the internet's screwed up again. And I'm like, why would it be? It's like 2 p.m. my time. I'm like, why do I have my day off, right? Would the internet be going out or whatever, right? It doesn't make sense. Like, it's weird. I'm not broadcasting. It would be one thing if I was broadcasting a special holiday event or something. Why is my internet going out again? All right? Now, just so you guys know, one thing that the tech had told me, he's like, if this happens again, you can easily go into your modem, change the settings they've messed up, or if you want to do it the easy way, just do a factory reset. Just if you do a factory reset of your modem, it knocks out anything they've messed with and sets it back to default and you'll be okay. Okay? So I go into my modem, all right? And this is that Wednesday. And once again, they've done it again. This is the same picture I'm going to show you, but just to reiterate, this is basically what they did, is they did all this again, okay? A second time. And I'm like, whoa. So it's a month later, and they're doing it again. Now, I'm trying to put it in my head, why would they be doing it on Wednesday, on my day off before Thanksgiving? And it dawned on me.
It's crazy that they blocked the word Phil, dude.
Okay? This person only has access to do this stuff certain days of the week and certain times when they're working. So likely this employee wasn't working on Thanksgiving, wasn't working on Black Friday, and I'm pretty confident that they don't work weekends. It seems like this is a person who works like day shift during like Monday through Friday, but of course it would have been the holidays. So it would have, you know, they wouldn't have had access. And what I'm thinking is they know I'm going to do a Thanksgiving Day stream. They know I'm going to do a Black Friday marathon. So they're going to put this in place and try to screw up my internet the day before all that, before they're out of the office. You know what I'm saying? So.
Right.
In my, you know,
just before they clock out.
What it was. They want to do it out
right.
the wall.
He's, okay. Wow, the fan fiction that he's created is so robust.
Before they're out the door for their
hot. It's a huge conspiracy theory. Literally a conspiracy theory.
Now, I fixed it.
Oh, he fixed it.
What I did is, again, I did myself. I did that factory reset, and I fixed both modems. By the way, it was both modems. It's not just one they're doing it with. It's both modems that they're doing this to. Both of my business lines. As I said, I have two lines of business internet in my home. So they reset. They screwed up both modems, and I manually did the reset to both modems to fix them, okay? So that now I could have internet again. So if you didn't notice, I didn't mention this at all. I didn't mention this on Thanksgiving. I didn't mention this on Friday. I didn't mention it at all over the weekend because the thing is, I don't want to give attention to trolls, okay? But what I did is I had the regional tech manager's phone number, and I called him, and I left a voicemail, and I said, you know, I'm sure you're probably not there because it's right before Thanksgiving, but I want to let you know this is still happening. So I don't know what, you know, investigation was launched a month ago, but here we are, you know, later and nothing's happened. It's basically this person still has access. They're doing it again. And obviously this isn't very good. I need you to look into it. I need you to call me back. Now, I don't know if you're on vacation, but call me back as soon as you get this message so we can talk about it and figure it out.
Oh my God.
So that was on.
You left a message for like the boss of
Wednesday.
Comcast for
okay.
the region,
that
man.
That was on Wednesday of last week. All right. So as you know, I streamed all week. No problems. Okay. No problems at all. All weekend, everything's fine. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Yesterday, Monday. So think of it. Person works at Comcast. They're only working weekdays, but they had a holiday weekend. Monday, when they would have been back in the office, the crap hits the fan. Okay? I mean, this is like, now we're getting really...
Yo, he leaked his IP.
What happened?
Apparently.
I'll tell you what happened. All right? You ready for this? First of all, this happened. They went to my modem, my Comcast modem, and they enabled the Wi-Fi, and they decided to name it Insulting
Piggy. Oh my God, look at this! The problem is, yo! This is
publicly
Greedy Piggy.
In the area.
Bruh!
And is driving around.
No way!
Looking at the internet.
No way!
That.
And Delete Was Hotter is how his Wi-Fi is called. And also Greedy Piggy.
So they did that.
Oh, no way!
One. That was the first thing they did. All right? Now, as you guys know...
What a huge pop.
...on and off yesterday. So what they were doing is, while I was broadcasting my normal stream, they were resetting my modem over
and
over.
Dude, I am deceased right now.
Continuously broadcast, okay?
This guy is the GOAT.
I started to ignore
the GOAT.
I was like, listen, if we can't keep, you know, streaming a game, then maybe what we'll do is we'll play something different.
And like, was hotter.
Game. I have a lingering game going on right now, and I'm like, maybe we can do the final hour.
Why did it take him so long to notice?
Hour, you know. So I guess that pissed the person off, because the person's like, wow, Phil's really not giving me any attention.
Oh,
so
shit.
What did they do? I'm going to tell you what they did. All right? Now, this is where it gets scary.
Uh-oh.
All right? This is where you're like, you got to be fucking kidding me. So listen to this. Since they weren't getting any attention logging into my modem and screwing with my internet, they logged into my business account itself, meaning all of the information that you have in your business account.
Hold up, what?
Including your name, your address, your phone number, your email addresses, your payment information, and all of that, your modem information. It's all listed in there, okay? They proceeded to not only go into there and mess with all of my information, which is against the law, by the way. You cannot do that. They also, get this, without my permission, took money away from me and
what?
Made a payment towards my Comcast internet bill for hundreds and hundreds of dollars.
They paid his internet on his behalf? What?
That's fraud. That is identity theft and fraud. You cannot do that.
They
that
paid his fraud. Fucking bills for
That's
him.
Not, oh, I'm messing with someone's internet. That's an actual serious crime. Okay? You cannot fuck around like that. And this person thinks at this point,
oh, no
they
way.
Can get away with anything. Okay?
They paid They've his bills, dude.
Years. It's been a month since the October incident. The cast has done absolutely nothing about it, right? So...
Oh my God.
Okay. Now, before you say, well, what evidence do you have? Well, I'm not going to show you my payment information, and I'm certainly not going to show you anything that's private, but what I will show you is what they did to my account.
Let's see this. Yeah, I would like to. So?
Oh, Panda Lee? So they logged into my account, and they changed the name on the account. They changed the email on the account. They basically changed everything. Okay? So there you go. All this information was changed.
I cannot believe this.
Okay? So not only did they do all of that, as you can see, all the information changed to be troll stuff.
Hey, what about the phone number?
And they also...
He leaked his phone number.
Made a false payment.
Dude literally revealed his phone number.
Towards me.
Oh my God.
Okay? So this is obviously awful, right? This is not, okay, someone's messing around anymore, right? It's not. This isn't. This is, whoa... Someone is seriously trying to hurt me. They're trying to take money out of my accounts and put it towards stuff that it's not supposed to be towards.
What, bills?
Right? And that's the problem. Like, that's horrible.
They paid his bills.
That's my accounts now, right? If they have this access. So...
It is fucked up, I have to say, but it's fucking hilarious.
I basically had to go offline. Like, if you remember, yesterday when I was live on stream...
Jesus Christ.
We're going to continue to stream and ignore the nonsense... I had to go offline because I had to immediately contact Comcast and say, you have to stop with all of this going on right now. You have to stop this payment. You have to stop this access, whatever it is. You have someone who could steal all my money. out of my account. So immediately what I did is I called them, and the person who, you know, I got from billing basically said, all right, I'm going to remove everything. So he removed the payment information. All that stuff's removed from my account now. So there's no way that they could keep processing payments in my name. Okay? Thankfully. So at least that's done. All right? But the problem now with that is now all my stuff's messed up. I'm on a contract with Comcast that they call it an auto pay discount. Meaning if you have your account set up on auto pay, you put your account information into their website, you set it up, you get a discount. Now I've lost my discount.
Oh my God, he lost his discount.
Did I do anything wrong to lose my discount? No. It's their own messed up system. Okay? So I was on the phone with Comcast yesterday for 2.5 hours. I talked to billing. I talked to customer, it's CSA, it's like customer security assurance, which is the fraud department. Okay.
Oh, he talked to the fraud guy. Billing,
and billing's like, we can't stop
the CEO of fraud.
What we're going to do is tomorrow we're going to look into it and see if it processes or not. And if it doesn't, we can try to stop it. If not, we'll keep the amount that you need for your bill anyway, and we'll credit you the rest. It's going to come right back to your account within a few days. I'm like, that's fair enough. Okay, that's fine. No big deal. But, you know, I need to have this so that no one has access to my information anymore. And they said, okay, so we're going to put you over to the fraud department. I explained the whole thing to the fraud department. And the fraud department says, okay, so here's a ticket number. I'm like, okay, I don't know what you want me to do with this. What are you going to do? Well, we have to file it. We have to escalate it. And I said, but what are you going to do? Are you going to call me? Are you going to follow up? Well, we don't know. All I'm doing is taking your information. You know, we don't know what's going to happen. But we'll take all your information and we'll look into it. Okay? So he puts me on hold. I'm not kidding you. The agent puts me on hold for 30 minutes. Okay? 30 minutes. Saying he's going to come back and tell me the results of all of this. He never comes back. Instead, he transfers me to the residential customer support department.
Oh, no. They sent him to the poor people.
I'm talking to says, I don't know why you're with me. I have no idea why you were transferred over to me. Because this, you know, I can't help you. This is obviously an error or something. The guy's messing with you. He says, so I'm going to put you back over to customer support. He puts me back to the guy in billing. And the guy in billing's like, I just talked to you for like 45 minutes and helped you as much as I could. Why did they put you back to me? I don't know. I don't know. I don't work for you. You know, I don't know what they're doing. So then he says, all right, I'm going to put you back to fraud. He calls the fraud department and he argues with the fraud department for 30 minutes that they're supposed to be helping me. Why did they put me in a circle? Right? Like, he's mad. The actual billing agent.
This story is so fucking long.
Fraud seems to be blowing me off and not helping me. Okay? So he's actually arguing with him behind the scenes. And finally, they put me back with fraud and the fraud guy says, all right, so what we're doing is, you know, we're going to have this filed. You have your ticket number. Yes, there's going to be a serious escalation that will be taken seriously, and we'll be contacting you about it. Okay. Now, what we want to do is we want to transfer you over to, the tech support. Why? Well, maybe tech support can help you. I said, I know they can't help me. All right, whatever. Transfer me over. So they transfer me over to tech support. I explained the situation. Oh, we can't do anything. No kidding. But what we're going to do, we're going to file a ticket. Oh, good. A ticket? You're going to file me a ticket, huh? Okay. So they file a ticket, and their end, where it says everything going on with the modem and how this person has the power to mess with my modem and all of that. Okay? So, all right, I guess, right? Fine. But will anything come of that? Who knows? Now, in the meantime, I call the regional manager of tech support twice. I actually had called him before.
Oh my God, he was tweaking out on the phone.
I had called him and left him.
It was like panic calling everybody.
You're probably just getting back from the holiday, but this is a serious issue. My internet's going down again.
But I do kind of understand him.
I called him after 2.5 hours of being on the phone with everyone else, left another voicemail. I said, hey, so just so you know, now I've been on the phone with fraud. I've been on the phone with everyone. Everyone says they're filing tickets, but no one seems to be able to help me. So what am I supposed to do when I need to broadcast tomorrow for work? I need your help. Please call me back ASAP. Okay? Now, in the meantime, I'm not the kind of person to just sit around like an idiot and let this happen.
Really?
Go get her, you know.
Really?
Say, okay. So rather than just sit around.
He's a go-getter, you guys. Phil.
Over and over and over.
Out of all people.
I'm going to do, initially, what I was told to do a month ago by that tech. I'm just going to get a new modem. So I went on Amazon, and I bought a modem, Rush. Send me a modem right now. And they did. I got a new modem last night during my late stream that's not a Comcast modem. Okay? So, it's a brand new, fresh modem. It has nothing to do with Comcast whatsoever.
You've been chopping up like crazy today, though. So, it's not working.
But with Comcast, you can't just have your modem work. You got to call them, and you got to give them the data off the modem, and then they set it up, and then it works. So, I had to call them late. It was like 11 p.m. last night, and I'm calling them. And, of course, you know, I'm trying to get this done, right? And there you go. And then they do it, and now it works, right? So now my internet's working, all right? And it's not on the old modem, the Comcast modem anymore. It's now on this new modem, okay? This third-party modem, all right? Great. So now I should have no issues, right? I should be in the clear. They shouldn't be able to access the modem because it's not a Comcast modem. They don't have the credentials to log into the modem and mess with it. They can't change the wireless settings. They can't put on filters. They can't do any of that crap, right? And by the way, obviously, I probably should have a new IP and I should have all this. It's all different because remember, the thing that happens with Comcast modems is really silly. It always seeks out the same IP address, but when you swap modems, you get a new IP address, okay? So, you know, there you go. Now, so all that, you know, goes down or whatever, all right? And I'm like, okay, so today, hopefully, number one, hopefully I'm going to get calls from Comcast. I'm going to get support. They're going to help me. I'm going to wake up in the morning, and I'm going to have multiple departments who are on this.
Oh, nothing like that happened.
Escalated it. Because when you call Comcast, oh, sir, your security is of our utmost concern. 100%. You have to understand, your security is our biggest concern. Okay? That's what they say. Now, this is someone who has access to my modem, someone who can mess with my business on a daily basis, and someone who has access to all of my business information and my payment information and is filing fake payments, committing fraud, which is a crime, and I have it all documented that it's all happening. I've saved all the information to prove that it's happening, and I filed claims with this company. I've got 3 voicemails in with the regional tech manager. So you know they're going to be right on top of this, right? Now, in the meantime, just to show you that, again, I'm not a slouch on this, I actually even contacted Xfinity's social media team. And I said, I don't know what to do in this situation. And they said, you got to go to the fraud team. I said, I did. Just so you know, I contacted that fraud team and I filed claims or whatever. I don't know what's going to happen, all right? But that's what they told me. Like, that's all you can do is you can contact the fraud team and that's it, all right? So.
Yeah, I gifted some memberships because this is a really hype stream. So enjoy your time.
Bushy-tailed and bright-eyed. I'm ready for the day because I'm feeling positive. Things are going to go good today, right? And I check my phone. I got no emails. I got no phone calls. I got no voicemails. Nothing. Zero. Nothing whatsoever from anyone. Okay? Am I surprised and shocked? No, I'm not. But you would think that a company that takes your security so seriously, and we have documented evidence that fraud just occurred with their system, that they would probably be on it to prevent anything further from going on. I mean, we're not just talking someone's messing with you. We're talking this could be a legal issue for them. Because my security has been compromised and it seems to be their fault. There is an internal employee doing all of this. Okay?
What if it's the CEO of Comcast?
All right. Well, I'm not expecting much, but you know what? Maybe today I will get contacted and, you know, and maybe they will handle it. I don't know. But anyway, I can stream now.
Yay. Right? Yeah.
Right?
But now we know the
so
whole story.
I turned on my stream this morning, and within a minute of it being live, the person resets my modem.
Oh, come on.
What this tells me is, even though Comcast doesn't have access to that modem. Like, they can't go in that modem and change its settings. They've got a reset button.
And wild. By the way, just real quick, remember how a couple days ago he mentioned that he's going to be the one who's going to decide when he's going to retire from YouTube, and now somebody is literally taking him down. So DSP, stop fucking challenging people, dude. They're fucking you every time. They win every fucking time.
They could press it right now during this live stream. They already did. They did before, and they could do it right now again. That they have the ability to do this whenever they want, okay? Which is absolutely stupid.
Stupid.
It's not their property. I didn't give Comcast permission to mess with my equipment.
You are now the troll's property. The trolls own you right now.
I didn't ever give them the right to do that.
And also, yes, Panda Lee was better.
They shouldn't have that access. And according to the tech that was at my house in October, they shouldn't have had access. But apparently they at least have the ability to reset the modem, because that's what they've been doing. They did it multiple times this morning when I was just turning the stream on, and I'm like, so I can't work. So I cannot do a live stream of gameplay. I cannot do a podcast. At any point during any stream, they could just keep hitting the reset button like this, right?
Really? So he's basically taken hostage right now.
Here. I got a few questions for Comcast, and I would love to get answers on this.
This dude is actually wild.
How do you have a company, all right, where you have employees that you don't monitor what they're doing? You don't have any audits of employee activity to see that there's no malicious stuff going on. What level of power are you giving your employees that they can log into modems, change settings, log into business accounts, see all the data, change all the data without permission? That's the other thing. There's no levels to prevent any of this. Apparently, they give their employees an insane amount of freedom. Okay? And the funny part is, like I said, this is proven, because some people are saying dump.
Yo, what if it's the mini PC? What if it's actually the mini PC and it had some fucking malware on it?
Here shows this is an employee login. He says there's different. He says if it was a customer login, or, you know, if you see different levels of login, he says this is an employee login. That's what that is.
I don't know. I'm just predicting, but if the guy from Comcast said it was an employee login and now he's getting taken down. Do we have F's in chat? Oh yeah, we do. Here we go. Yeah, let's go. Oh my God.
Ain't nobody gonna tell me how to live.
Fuck all you hoes.
Oh man, what a fucking saga. This just, all right, but it did pay off having zero expectations, because this is a content nuke for everybody. Everybody's gonna be picking this apart to no end. We got a solid number 2 in the top 10 worst DSP moments of this year. This is a solid number 2, and he is fucking gone. Apparently, nobody said he's back. There's people praying for him in chat. They're saying, "Please God, help Phil." We got more buffering emotes. He's gone. He vanished. Somebody took him down. So let's recap this. Somebody from Comcast, which is confirmed by the guy from Comcast who went to DSP's house, somebody from Comcast is remotely logging into his modem, tweaking it, changing the password, not the password, changing the username to, not the username, the SSID, the network name, to stuff like Panda Lee is better and Greedy Pig Roach. Then what happens is, they pay his Comcast bill by force, essentially. They take money from his account and they force a payment to Comcast worth hundreds and hundreds of dollars. Nobody cared. Nobody did anything about it.
Here's your example right there.
Okay, he's back.
Just went out and came back. So this person, again, hit the reset button. So they have the ability to reset my modem whenever they want. They can just...
So he's somebody's bitch right now, big time.
They don't have power to do anything else. They can't mess with the
big time
modem or anything, but they can reset the modem. Okay, so that's number one.
Apparently, they're giving it to him hardcore.
Comcast have unlimited power. They could do it. I mean, they have access to your modem. They have access to your financials. They have access to everything, and they can do whatever they want with it. And there's no, you know, who's checking, who's auditing, who's making sure that they're doing the work that they're supposed to be doing, and not messing with your stuff. And again, can you imagine if you were any streamer or anything like that? Right, anyone could be at risk. At this point, anyone, All right, so that's number one. Number two,
I could be at risk. Everybody's at risk now.
A situation like this is identified.
Jade is at risk.
Okay, this is a serious thing. It's fraud. It's you know, malicious actions from an employee. It's been identified. It was a month ago. This was identified by the tech. Okay? A month ago.
What if it was the tech?
It was identified by the tech. Not yesterday. Over a month ago. It was October 28th. Okay? So yeah, exactly a month ago, actually. And supposedly that tech talked to their regional manager, and supposedly that regional manager said they were going to get involved in the launching of an investigation, some kind of an internal audit security team or whatever it was. That was a month ago. Why did Comcast never contact me to tell me what was going on, right? Why did Comcast never follow up with me to assure me that things had been fixed? Why did Comcast just blow this off?
Damn, this is already like an hour worth video.
Do they think that my 9.5 years as a customer is a joke? Do they think that my viewer base, my business is a joke?
Absolutely.
Do they not, or is it just that they don't care?
Probably.
That even though they claim, your security is our biggest concern in this, they actually don't give a crap.
You should sue them.
They say all that, they blow smoke up your butt, but they don't care. I mean, right now, I can't actually contact anyone at Comcast who knows anything about this situation. If I call, you get a line level person who doesn't know anything, you tell them the situation, and they'll be like, okay, we'll file an escalate.
Oops. Seems he got escalated right now. And do we have Fs again, or it's, yep, we do have Fs again. People are gonna start praying for him in chat now. Oh man, this guy is having a field day. He might get fired from Comcast if it is actually a person on the inside. But he's giving us so much fucking content. I'm so glad. Prayer hands in chat for that mystery person at Comcast. It was all worth it, mystery person. It was all worth it. I promise. I promise. And now he's been put on pause. He got timed out. This chat is very entertaining right now. More than he was. But today he actually brought the big guns. Today he's being entertaining as hell. This story is one of twists and turns and everything in between, man. This is an all-timer story. The day people hacked DSP's internet will remain in history. He's going to be bringing that shit up until he dies, like legit. It's going to set him back by years. That's how he's going to claim years from now. When he moves back to Connecticut and he lives with his parents, he's going to claim that this is what destroyed his job. This one guy at Comcast who was never caught. They never found the guy. He should just sue him instead. He could probably get a bunch of money if he sues him. And he's right. He can get a shit ton of money. You should get his bankruptcy lawyer to actually represent him, since she did a very good job last time at essentially tard wrangling him. So yeah. This is super hype. Is he still gone, like legit? Yeah, somebody terminated him, like, damn. But this goes back again, like I said, a couple days ago, he's talking about that he's gonna leave the internet by his own terms, and whenever he decides. Well, I see something a little bit different now. I think somebody just took it upon themselves to do it, and Phil can't do anything about it. So maybe he shouldn't talk all that trash, because remember back in the day, right before the leaks happened, when he went on Twitter and he said, "Fuck the Kiwi farts. I know you guys support me. Fuck all the trolls." And he basically stoked the fire. He basically provoked people to mess with him. And this is kind of the thing that happens when you provoke the internet to mess with you and you can't back it up. His mouth is writing checks that his ass can't cash because his ass is bankrupt. So there we go. And I guess chat is back. Okay, so let's refresh and see if we're going to get lucky or this is just another lie, just another fraud. Oops, are we back? It's loading way too long.
Three times during this broadcast.
Oh, yeah, he's back.
They can literally do it over and over and over. All right.
Now, it's like a lag switch, literally. Dude, somebody literally hit him with a lag switch that they got.
Only seems to happen during certain days and certain times.
And he's getting violated right now.
This is an employee who goes in and works a certain time of day, and that's when they have access to everything. But I've noticed usually it doesn't happen at night. It certainly didn't happen during the holiday weekend, which is weird. This is why it's really, really weird, okay? Because why, if this is the case, And this is going on. And it's an employee of Comcast doing it, which all the evidence points towards. Okay? The way I see it is they would have shut me down during the Thanksgiving stream. They would have shut me down during the Black Friday marathon.
How do you know?
Those are far more important events. You know what I'm saying? They are. They're just far more important events than a normal daily stream. Like, yeah, yesterday it sucks. I couldn't stream Modern Warfare 3, you know, like I was supposed to. Today, right now, I should be streaming my podcast and I should be getting the Super Mario RPG.
Oops. I guess he's not. Wait, but wait, wasn't this a segment about the whole reason he's recording it is to send it to Comcast so they can do something about it? But he's talking about like the stupid schedule and shit. And this is already like an hour and a half video. Nobody's watching this, dude. And he's gone again. They lag switch his ass. Oh man, the Comcast is the GOAT. The GOAT.
That's why he's the GOAT!
I cannot believe this is happening. This is some madman shit. But the interesting thing is that he implied that the side-scrollers are somehow involved with this. Because when he had the interview, things started happening. And when he came back, Keemstar joined. So he's trying to make a logical connection to that when there isn't much. It's like he's just the confirmation bias. It's something that he wants to believe. And it's not really fair, I think. Even though I do think somebody actually might have hacked his ass.
Oops. I should be getting the Super Mario RPG.
No, he's gone. We went back to the point where he got disconnected. He's actually gone. They took him down, legit. So I guess he was wrong. Somebody can just take him off the internet by force, and there's nothing he can do about it. Unlike what he was claiming the other day. Well, that's pretty ironic, I would say. Yeah, we're still not back. People in his chat. So many people showed up. Almost 800 people showed up for this. But now they dropped to like almost 700. Because there isn't anything to watch. Unlike here, where there is a lot to watch. Yep. So I guess we can do some pop-ups, you guys. Let's just resume that. Let's see what we got. Thanks, everybody.
His cat inside is going ultra instinct.
Well, I don't blame him. What is happening to him is pretty crazy. I didn't even know people can do that.
Hey, is the right channel now, house in danger? Podcast, and I have unlimited internet, meaning I can.
Okay, he's back. He's back.
There's no caps or limits on the internet, so it allows me to stream as much as I need. They give me the speed I need to stream and upload. So no matter who else I go with, right? Sadly, they're not going to really give me the quality of the service that I have with Comcast. It was the same. It was the same back in Connecticut. In Connecticut, I was stuck with Cablevision / Optimum Online, where they were the only ISP in the area that would give good internet to where I lived. And they weren't that good. Like, it had issues. So that's eventually one of the reasons why I actually moved. You know? But for me, this is just the problem here is I don't know what to do. I'm not getting any help. And that's really why I'm doing this stream and why I'm doing this video today. I didn't want to have to tell you guys this story and show you the evidence. You know, you look at something like this. This is just creepy shit. This is someone, you know, who works at Comcast, who is a nut job. They're putting insulting things into my modem.
Yeah, see, you know this. Panda Lee was hotter than the greedy piggy. How long did it take him to figure this out?
And you're allowing them to do this because I told you about it a month ago, right? And no one did anything.
It's the funniest shit.
So I really don't know what to do. All right? I put in all the logs, and so far I've heard nothing from Comcast. I haven't gotten a call back from the regional manager. All right? The social media team said...
You should provoke the guy that's doing this. That's what you should do. You should tell him, what you gonna do? What are you gonna do when I come for you?
You know?
When Snortomania lands on your ass.
So, I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
Cut a promo on him. You know, like, tell him you're coming for him.
This exactly. This person could just sit there and hit reset, reset, reset on my modem. And they have gotten away with it up to this point. So it's obvious they're under the impression they're going to keep getting away with it, right? And I really have no recourse and no way to fix it. So what am I supposed to do? Now, it's hilarious because you got people in the chat. Lawyer up.
Wow.
Great. How does that fix
it? It's a hardcore burp.
I have to work. You know what you have to do when you get a lawyer?
I have to work.
You pay them money in order for them to do the work. You understand that,
can
right?
They just do it pro bono because you're going to get bajillion dollars in return?
Lawyers aren't free. So how do I pay for the lawyer?
You should get Saul Goodman.
If I can't stream to make money to hire and pay the lawyer. Get it? So people are like pro bono. Oh, yes.
Yeah, he should pay him an exposure. He should give him a shout out. That's what he should do.
Pro bono lawyer sitting around right now.
Give the guy a shout out.
Take the case on this one. They're really seeing giant dollar signs of a small time streamer, right? Who can't stream consistently. Like, wait. So I could. The only thing I'm thinking of is I could try to switch ISPs. But I'd have to look into, like, who are the competing ISPs and who will offer...
Oh, my God. He needs feedback for that.
Something that's
competing ISPs.
Unlimited what the Comcast...
And you bet your ass the LolCow podcast is going to be talking about this shit. Because this shit is just too good for nobody else to talk about. This is wild.
So that's number one. Number two, I would need it that it's as fast as what I have. And to my knowledge, okay... To my knowledge, I don't think that anything out here is as good as what Comcast offers, right? So, everyone's saying ridiculous things. Change your password. Don't you think I did? Don't you think the minute that...
And now he's shitting on everybody suggesting stuff. After like an hour of telling everybody he's helpless, he's shitting on every suggestion.
They don't need my password to log into the account. This is an employee. You see, this is the point. If someone went into my modem and my account... on Comcast and literally change it to say the same malicious stuff on both, you know it's the same person, and they're given pretty much unlimited access to any customer's information with no authorization. That's my thing. Where's the authorization? There's no evidence that I called and asked for anything. They just are just doing it of their own volition. They just go in and do whatever they want, right?
They got the ultimate lag switch. What was what was causing all the lag every time he plays Street Fighter?
So I really don't know what to do.
Imagine that. I don't actually believe that, but it would be absolutely hilarious.
I'll leave this video, all right? I'm curious what the next step is. Is Comcast now going to actually step up and handle the situation? Because I had to do this today because I can't stream. I can't do my work. And people are going to say, why can't Phil do his work? This is why. I had to tell you, you know? So, hopefully, now, Comcast will do something, and they will fix the problem.
So,
whether they find out who it is, they terminate them, or they put my account under some kind of a special lockdown so no one can be accessing my...
Yeah, put DSP on lockdown.
Right? Like, this is ridiculous.
He's not going anywhere anyways. It's
acceptable that someone just has unlimited power to sit there and go, reset.
He doesn't realize that this is just the whole segment telling everybody how vulnerable he is and how he can do nothing about it, therefore encouraging more actions like this.
Reset. Right? How
doesn't he realize how stupid making this segment is?
At all? Against this at all. No prevention. At all.
Oops. He got his lag switched again. Oh no! Oh, we did it again, you guys. Exclamation lag switch in chat to pause DSP stream at any time. And look at how funny of a face you can make. That's going to be a new challenge. Hashtag lag switch DSP. And he's gone again. This dude is having a field day. Whoever is, somebody might be just sitting in an office owned by Comcast somewhere, just pressing the reset button every 10 minutes and just laughing his ass off. It's wild. But this whole story, man, like, we haven't reached anything of this magnitude in a long time. And it got him showing screenshots of his control panel. Oh, the dude changed his Wi-Fi to Panda Lee, it was better. And Greedy Piggy. They blocked the word Phil from being used, which is super random. Like, I don't know how that's gonna hurt him, blocking the word Phil. But they also blocked PayPal.com on the whole network. And YouTube and Twitter. It's fucking crazy. And yeah, I did hear he leaked his IP. So now shit is gonna get even worse. Because it's fucking DSP. Of course he's gonna do that. Of course he's gonna do that. Even though I didn't notice any IP. I did see some MAC addresses of all his devices. Which is not very good. You shouldn't be having your MAC address out there on the internet. It's definitely not a good thing. I can't confirm about the IP. I actually haven't seen it. But I did see some MAC addresses at first. As you guys know, we're watching this live. Is it back? I guess it is back. People in the chat saying that they're scared. What the fuck are they scared for?
At all. This at all. No prevention. Then let's figure it out together. Give me a point of contact to talk to.
Oh, it was the local IP. Okay, then that's just useless. Now,
and I'm you guys.
It was a
just so I have someone
196 style IP.
On a daily basis. You know what I'm saying?
But I didn't see it myself, so I don't know.
That's
I just saw MAC addresses. It's not very good.
Right? Everything else is just stupid. All the other suggestions are things down the line. Because here's the thing. Yeah, if this never gets fixed, right? Then I could potentially look for legal action and say, well, what about the damages? Well, I should have been able to work this day, and I couldn't because my internet didn't work because Comcast didn't fix the problem. And that's when you have the lawyer involved. The lawyer is not
going to fix my internet. But dude, imagine if he actually gets millions of dollars from Comcast.
And fix the internet so I can
because if this story is to be believed, if it's 100% correct, verified by that Comcast employee, he can actually win a shit ton of money from them.
You hear what I'm saying? Like, that's one of the dumbest things I've ever heard.
Because they ignored him and everything, but okay. I don't think it will ever get near that.
I thank everyone for watching the video. If you were watching the stream, you missed several portions because it kept going down because this troll kept turning off my stream, but it comes back up.
He might get somebody from Comcast to become a member, though. That would be cool. Maybe they're going to gift them like 10 memberships.
This will get fixed, all right? Thank you all for listening. My apologies to all of my viewers and fans because I absolutely would love to do normal work for you guys. You know, I'm not one for drama. I don't care about this shit.
Yeah, they're going to play this pre-stream in court. That's exactly what they're going to do.
Guys, and I'm not able to do it right now because of a malicious...
And it's all going to be streamed on the internet. This is going to be the greatest event of all time.
That's it. I'm going to end the video here. Please, someone from Comcast, contact me so that we can get this resolved.
He's legitimately expecting them to actually reach out to him. This is how wild he is. They're expecting him. He's expecting them to watch this video. That it's a 1 hour.
I'm owning this. I'm going to fix this. Instead, I got now 2 days of work I can't work, and now we're looking at potentially more and more down the road if you don't fix this right away. All right. So, all right, guys. That's the video. Thanks for watching. If I have an update for you, I'll let you know. Okay. Okay, guys. So, FYI, I'm going to take a brief break. I'm not going anywhere. I'm still going to be here. All right? But what I want to do, I got to pee quick. So, I'm just going to take a brief break. I'm going to come back and we can hang out for a bit and talk about this, talk about options and things you guys want, you know. Right now, I mean, is there a point of me trying to do a game on this stream? Probably not. Now, like I said, so far, this internet has not been interrupted at night, as if this person only has access to this stuff during the day. I don't know, but I'd like to just kind of hang out for a bit with you guys and talk. And by the way, there's contributions that have come in. I want to shout out those contributions.
Now we're going to do shout outs.
So just give me a minute or two. I'm just going to run and use the restroom.
What?
And I'm going to come right back and we're going to continue.
Yeah, he's definitely not going to go use the restroom. That's definitely not happening. He's going to go vibe check his modem or something. Oh man, what a segment. I'm gonna resume the pop-ups now, so let's catch up on everything.
Cat on standby waiting to pull the plug.
Yeah, Cat, imagine, Cat is actually the one doing this. And Cat from inside the house is changing the Wi-Fi settings. So it's all Cat's fault. I'm pretty convinced.
He looks like a BMW man.
Well, yeah, you must have watched the WPIG from today, because that was what it was about, the BMW lease.
He's asking to be doxxed.
Well, he already has been, so it's you can't just ask for more than that. It's already happened.
Praise be the Comcast employee.
Yes. Let's go, Comcast. Clap, 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 clap.
Is he actually trying to insinuate him dropping when they asked him to show his WWE account was planned?
Yes. Because,
dude, this is incredible.
Because he tried to make the connection between the side scrollers and his internet going off, and it didn't make any fucking sense, because it doesn't make sense. Is he implying that Craig is in cahoots with a guy from Comcast to expose him? Like, that's just going into, like, conspiracy theory levels. Big up Sweeb for becoming a member, dude. Next one. I'm gonna have to read the rest myself, because otherwise it's gonna be just people becoming members. Or I can skip them, actually. Alright, hold on, because I gotta catch up properly on this.
At Meerkat, he had a pay pig paying his bills now.
Yeah, pretty much. But with his own money, though. So he got his bills paid by force, effectively. That's pretty much what happened. Yeah, I gifted some memberships early on, so congratulations to everybody who got them, and thank you very much to the person who gifted some himself. Big ups Omega Kirk for the 5, and big ups, one moment. I can't see it, dude. Oh yeah, Mad Max the 7th, thank you for the 5, dude. Okay, right, we're gonna catch up on the rest later.
What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do more.
If I happen to miss somebody, just tag me in chat and tell me what you send, and I'll get to it. And I'm sorry.
That first video that I just made was about 50 minutes, but that was the story. Now I'm gonna hang out with you guys, because obviously there's no point in trying to do gameplay right now because I can't, because the internet's gonna keep resetting. But I want to hang out with you guys regardless. And I have things to talk about, like, for example, we've got shout-outs to do, and I got an update already, so I'm going to start recording again just so you guys know, but if this stream...
Wait, what?
Just stick around. It's going to come back.
We got an update already.
Okay. Alrighty, everyone. So welcome to a special vlog and hangout session. Right now, my internet is all screwed up, and apparently I have no way to stop it from being reset by a malicious troll who apparently works for Comcast. Yeah, I know. I made a whole separate video about that if you want to check it out. It's a 55-minute video. Explains the whole situation. Has evidence. Really messed up stuff in that video. Definitely give it a look. But in the meantime now, I'm just going to hang out with you guys because I can't... what's the point of playing a game, right? But I just want to let you guys know I have an update. Oh, I have a big, important update.
Oh, wow. That's going to be wild. Nothing happened.
Community support? Twitter account. Oh, goodness. We understand the urgency of your situation. We want to help in any way we can. Our customer security assurance team, which is their fraud team, who I've already talked to, can help make this right. This organization has been established to ensure a safe and secure online experience for Comcast customers. This team is a dedicated group of security professionals who...
What if the fraud team is just there to commit fraud instead of investigating it? What if that's a thing?
Online fraud and others...
I don't know.
Gee, I wonder if this is copy-pasted from somewhere.
Yeah, it absolutely is.
I'm sorry to hear you have not been contacted by them yet. I'm confident they will reach out to you soon and will help you make this right. By the way, here's a link to the security department. What do I need that for? I already filed a ticket. What do I need?
Oh, get fucked, bozo.
We will continue to check in with you to make sure the team is able to fix it. Thanks. That was really useful.
You're welcome.
Very, very useful information. So I checked. Nope, nothing from Comcast. I've gotten absolutely no responses whatsoever. Nothing from the fraud team. Nothing from the tech team.
He should be a part of the fraud team because he's so good at it.
Tech manager, nothing. Nothing. So, great, right? So I'm supposed to sit here with my thumb up my butt.
Yep.
Unable to work because Comcast will not act on this.
Right now, he is quite literally being held hostage.
You know, maybe Comcast actually is acting on it. Maybe. Because I just did this stream and they're about to get word of it. They're about to have an internal meeting about it. And they're going to sit down and they're going to say, oh, crap. Right? We got a situation where, you know, we need to handle this right away. Because now we look awful because this person just made a video about it or a stream about it. like I said, with over 1,000 people who watch this live stream, and I'm sure now the word of this is going to get out.
Really?
I have all my drama people talking about it, who always talk about me. You're all going to be talking about this, right? We've got the evidence that it is an employee at Comcast.
I'm not like really trying to help you, to be honest, though.
The smoking gun, there's two pieces of evidence that make it indisputable it's a Comcast employee. The first is that, basically, that's my kitty. The first is that the login to the modem shows as an employee login, right? You can see it says right on it. It doesn't say customer login or remote. It says employee login. So that is an employee that's logging into the modem to do those malicious things. That's number one. The other is that not only did they go into my modem, but they went into my other Comcast account to change it, and it was the same matching trollish messages and things. And the only way they could have done that is if they had access. Now, how would they have access to both? Because they're an employee to Comcast. You see? So there you go. Anyway. All right, guys. Let's continue. So I have shout-outs to do. Right?
Yeah, me too.
So to everyone who super chatted, including Rich.
Rich. Review Tech USA sent him like $10 to make a joking message.
Update the leaderboard, okay?
I don't even remember what it was.
So let me get down the leaderboard. All right.
We do the schedule now, boy.
Yeah, we gotta do the schedule. Come on, what's with the shoutouts?
Now, several
tips
came in.
Now,
shout these out. All right, I got a $10 tip.
This is the part where I'm gonna start pausing and shit because it's not important anymore.
From an anonymous tipper, says, I like all your shows. I hope you can get the mess figured out. This is terrible. I agree. And I appreciate
it. Isn't it obvious? Cat hates him and went detractor.
Absolutely. It's Cat's fault.
You saying
the that call is coming from inside the house.
I appreciate your support.
Absolutely what's happening right now.
Thank you for the tip.
Greatest season finale ever. Thanks to our man on the inside. Piggy is so hated and such a soapbag, people will risk their careers just to get to him.
Wait, this is not a season finale.
All heroes wear capes.
This is when we begin. This is not even a finale. This is where the saga begins. This is the beginning of a season.
Okay.
Yeah, not all heroes wear capes. Some of them...
Heading into work and this has made my day 10x better. Smiley face.
It's really fucking scandalous, dude. Yeah, not all heroes wear capes. Some of them wear Comcast branded shirts.
All right.
Caller alert. He's so single-minded. Just upload offline playthroughs until this is fixed. And commentary.
Well, how?
He'll sit around and cope.
How's he gonna get paid then?
He's going to get the... Sorry, we cannot provide business connections in your area. You can look for another provider or take this dial-up.
That would be wild.
Comcast guy should have downgraded his plan to a lower speed for a laggy
Captain
experience
DCW.
And limited data,
thank
forcing him to pay
DCW
per gig, making his bill
out.
Inflated.
Yo, imagine. That would have been crazy, but I don't know if they can do that.
Account situation again, I pray folded hands, medium skin tone.
Oh, I don't know, man. I don't know what kind of data you need to pull something like the Wings thing. I don't know what you need for that.
And I received a $2 tip.
And shout out to Cody Taylor, who used to work for Comcast. This is his message.
Worked at Comcast for years. This is an instantly completed investigation. There are logs of each login and it's an instant firing.
Right.
This is BS.
I've worked as a system administrator. I know everything has logs. Every kind of login to everywhere has logs on a server somewhere or some kind of an application that is meant to collect them. I've installed such applications, so I know that it exists. But it all depends on whether or not they're actually going to conduct an investigation.
Well-articulated email to Comcast threatening legal action. Trust me, when you do that, it'll be escalated immediately to their legal department.
All of
they
this
will
is an attempt to move to straight podcast after realizing he makes more bonus than gameplay.
That's too much of a stretch, I would say. He wouldn't go through something like this just for that.
Detriment to your business, endanger the prolonged financial...
I don't think he exaggerates almost everything that has ever happened to him, but I don't think he just makes stuff up out of thin air. At least not this time.
...is occurring every day. Will need to be recuperated in a future lawsuit. That's great. But who do I send it to? There's no one to send anything to. There's
Burnell
no email address.
Made a video. We need to have an emergency meeting with the CFO about this and stop everything we are doing to help Phil.
That's literally what is happening right now.
That you can email.
Guys, the Burnell video has dropped. We need to do something now. The stock is tanking.
Comcast support for business is a phone line. There is no. You could talk to a bot online, a chat bot, or that'll file you over to someone who's in another country, who's like an overnight chat person who can't actually help you, because all they do is they file the information and then they just cycle you to someone else later on, or you call. There's no, here's our very urgent matters email address to email to that doesn't exist.
This is actually really crazy because he's supposed to have the business line of support, you know, the business level of support, and he got nothing like that. He just got what everybody else gets, apparently.
Okay, and like I said, I've already left 3 voicemails with the regional tech manager.
Oh my god.
There's now a
he blew up his phone
department, and there's a case with the tech department. I've done everything I can on my end besides what I just did. The stream I just did was the last resort. Like, that's the most I can possibly do, right? The absolute most that I could possibly do. I have no other power to do anything else. Okay? So, you know, we'll see what happens now. Again, you would think that this is the last straw. I absolutely... Keep in mind, I kept this under wraps for a month. Like, this was... We figured this out a month ago when the tech was at the house. Was originally when we figured out this was all going on. So, you know, I kept it quiet for a month. Didn't
imagine
say a word about it.
Saying in the whole... Comcast prevented him from working. As though he can't turn his stream off and go get a job. He's delusional.
Well, that's exactly how that case would be. The whole argument would be that they prevented him from working and he lost a bunch of money. Therefore, he's entitled to some kind of a payment, you know?
Was doing the right thing. That they were looking into it. They were going to fix it. You know what I mean?
Big ups, $3.99.
Took it lightly and didn't care and brushed it under the rug and thought, oh, it would just go away. But now, fraud has happened. Someone took my money out of my account. Now, Comcast is going to make it right later today. Like they even said, we're going to have they're going to fix it and it's going to be refunded, you know. And that's good, but now I've lost my discount for auto pay. That's what I was saying during the video.
Oh no.
My system with Comcast for my bills. Well, now I lose that discount.
Oh,
I can't do it cuz I can't give them my financial information cuz some idiot can just make fake payments in my name now. How is that fair? Right? That doesn't make any sense at all. It's nuts, right? So they've got to fix it. You know, they really do. They've got to do something. I mean, again, to my extent, I've done everything that I could possibly do, right? Besides switch ISPs. Like, that's the one thing that I can do is I can completely switch internet service providers. But
he needs more lines of internet.
Of an internet service provider that's as good as Comcast that gives you unlimited internet without caps.
Select troll name from Phil's modem. Come on, Comcast.
Oh, yeah. Select troll name from Phil's modem. But no, Cody Taylor is absolutely right. You can find that guy in a split second. But the problem is whether or not they're going to try.
Need that to stream and gives you the speeds that Comcast does so that I can stream.
But regardless if whether or not that guy's going to be found, we got this segment, which is like an all-timer hype segment.
You know what I'm saying? I don't know what else I can do. What do you mean talk to them face to face? Who? Talk to who? Go to the local store where there's just a bunch of line level people just like you and me getting paid probably minimum wage. Yell at them. You think they're going to fix it? Do you see what I'm saying here? Like, I need a resolution. I don't need to piss off someone who doesn't need to be pissed off. There's Jasper in the background, by the way. No, don't jump up there, buddy. That's the Christmas decorations. You know,
something is definitely very fishy in this whole situation. It stinks, but I believe some of it is correct.
The internet so I can work. That's what this is all about. Fixing the internet so I can work consistently. That's what I want to do. I don't want drama. I don't want bullshit. I just want to work. I just want to be left alone so I can stream and have fun with my audience.
You are doing that right now.
I received a very generous.
Oh, yeah. $150.
I want to say thank you so much to 1 Minute Man, $100. Okay. So thank you, 1 Minute
of
Man.
Of course.
So much for that.
The cuck.
That's obviously going to help at least
in the flesh.
Yesterday that was screwed up, and today. So thank you for that. He says, have you considered Starlink? Now here's the thing. I don't know much about it. Is that not satellite internet? If it is, that's I'm telling you right now. I'll tell you right now that likely it ain't going to work, and here's why. Right now, my cell phone where I live is not great reception. Okay? It's not. My cell phone is bad reception. So, if I were to try to get if my cell phone, which is based on satellite, right, is bad, then probably obviously, if I get Starlink internet, that also is going to be bad. Maybe that'll change in the future. But for now, like when I first moved here, of course, this was 9 years ago, I did look into the satellite internet and it was atrocious. The speeds were like snails. But
sorry,
I mean, that was 9 years ago.
Please recap the whole show, THX, pig, pig, pig.
It's too much. Basically, check the pinned message. There's a detractor at Comcast.
The fraudulent payment. It's investigated.
Yeah. And they're probably going to end up giving his money back and everything. Yeah, as long as there's money involved, they're definitely going to investigate. It's 100%. You got a very good point.
For me, I think it would be more a reception issue.
And that guy's going to get nuked out of the company.
You know?
But that guy is not me, so...
Andy, that would never work, though. He says,
emoji? But thanks for the content, dude. You're a real soldier for this.
Pay-as-you-go.
Like, legit.
So it's not a contract. We're looking for a new ISP. How? Are you even aware of those? Do they exist?
This is like an all-time hilarious DSP segment.
Mobile data, which means it's going to be slow. It's not going to be fast to stream. It would be when you in this case, this is a new modem, so they can't go into this modem and maliciously mess with my settings and do stuff, right? But the hitting reset is annoying because I can't stream consistently. You're gonna have these.
And at the moment, all I have to think about is the story that he gave us, because I got no other experience, right? Especially with like Comcast shit like that. I don't know how it works. So this is going to be interesting for everybody's seeing what people's perspective on this is going to be. It's like we got Cody Taylor here. He's obviously got some experience in this. And there's going to be other people, networking engineers, so on and so forth, who's going to chime in.
Okay.
It's going to be a very interesting discussion.
Well, if anyone has any suggestions, like if you think...
How about you get a job?
ISPs, I'm open to suggestions.
They can lag switch you if you got a job.
I'm open to suggestion. All right.
And they're lag switching him right now. Oh, that's what I mean. Just get a job. Just go flip burgers or something. They can't lag switch you there. Just remember, I like a big Coke, no ice. Should we restart? Should we refresh? Let's freshen up a little bit. Let's get a raw fill, a brand new fill.
Let's put it that way. I'm open to suggestion.
He is open to suggestions, and then he's gone. I guess he is closed for suggestions officially. Oh, it's very interesting what the speculation around this is going to be. I like the idea that some people don't believe absolutely anything he says. Some people believe some of what he says. Some people have experience in the field to debunk what he says. It's very interesting. This is going to make a lot of people put out some very interesting videos and discussions. And of course, the LolCow podcast is going to talk about this. Of course they will. Because Phil is now an honorary member of the LolCow podcast. And then Freakly Professor sends him a €2 super chat. Says, Phil, I really should go to the police. Okay, I mean, if this guy wants to go to the cops on DSP's behalf in the European country he's from, then go for it.
Let's put it that way. I'm open to suggestion.
He's open to suggestion again. And then he's closed again. Fantastic. Chat is now not loading, but it's still going because I got it pulled up in a separate tab, so we got it all good. It's all on point. It's very interesting because he could possibly have a case in court. I just don't know if he's going to be able to go through with it or willing. It's very interesting, very interesting. Somebody changing the names of his Wi-Fi. They're trying to block words and stuff. Because, you know, DSP can't do that himself. He doesn't even know how to use OBS. He can't log into his control panel for the modem and start changing stuff to make it look like somebody else did it. He's not that smart. He's actually a very stupid guy. He's not an actual supervillain or something like that. So, but the real question is, where did this actually come from? Because, you know, you got the mini PC in play, which has been, if I want to mess with DSP and I'm thinking of all the possibilities, it is a possibility to give him a virus on the mini PC and just let him just plug it into the network. Then you got free access to the network. But I don't know. I don't know. Maybe it's a thing that's been going on for a long time. Like he claims, it's been going on for months, ever since the side scrollers thing. He tried to make some kind of a connection to them which to me is too much of an accusation based on pretty much nothing. It's all like speculation from him. But at the end of the day, he made like an hour and something minute video that Comcast are supposed to watch. And in this video, he picked his nose, he grunted, he cleared his throat, he burped a couple of times pretty significantly. So yeah, I'm sure whoever is watching that video from Comcast, of course, if that even happens, is going to have a field day. Is he still gone? People in his chat saying, Phil, I'm worried now.
Quick tips.
Oh no, we're doing quick tips now. We're all back. We're shouting out tips. We're back. I mean, of course he's going to make a lot of money from this because it's a huge situation.
Appreciate that.
His whole economy is what I call the emergency economy,
and,
where he makes huge amounts of money whenever an emergency happens, which subliminally makes him kind of low-key hope for more emergencies to happen. And whenever he has a stream like this, he's raking it in because that's the nature of the beast.
From Hotel Dude. Do you think about streaming from your phone or hooking your PS up to your phone? Again, as I said, it would not be good enough. It would not be good enough. There's just no, it's not, you know, sadly, it's not high enough quality. For what I do, it's one thing if I'm doing like low quality 480p, even, you know, pixelated 720p, and I want to stream from like a phone hotspot or something like that, that would not be good enough, you know? So someone had suggested, just because I'm coming back on the internet now, so people should be able to hear me. Someone suggested ATT Fiber. I don't know anything about that, ATT Fiber. I'm not aware of it. I'm not aware how it works. Right? You know, I'm just not aware of how that works, if it's in my area. I would have to look into that. I don't know. I don't think fiber's allowed here. Like, ATT will give me internet, but it'll be the crappy cell phone level satellite internet. You know what I'm saying? It won't be the right thing. So, by the way, my nose itches. If you guys give me a second just to quickly blow my nose, I'm about to sneeze.
Oh yeah, legit. That's what we're doing now. We're quickly blowing the nose type of segment. Very nice. So he's gone again. But yeah, the thing that was interesting is the whole thing of the guy forcefully paying his bills. So apparently that guy has some kind of authority to force a payment through his bank account towards Comcast, which is something that DSP claims happened, and it cost him hundreds of dollars. So that is going to be the nail in the coffin for Comcast, I think. Since it's money involved, it's going to be crazy.
Okay. All you gotta do is refresh, guys, because people are saying, you know, it keeps cutting out. Well, my internet right now is fine, but it will cut out again. I mean, what can you do? This guy's gonna keep hitting reset, you know?
Well, the more you tell him you're helpless and vulnerable, the more he's gonna keep doing it. Haven't you figured it out yet? This is the one thing on the internet you shouldn't do, is telling people how they can fuck with you and how vulnerable you are to people fucking with you in that specific way. Because then this happens.
Yeah, so what am I going to do moving forward, says Joeloft. I don't know. That's what I mean. Like, this has all happened within the last 2 days, right? Like, a month ago it was discovered, and then they tried to do it on Wednesday. And I, you know, like I said, I reset the modems, that fixed it, right? But now it seems like they're doing it constantly. Like, this is the first time that they've been doing it constantly. So, you know, I genuinely don't know at all what to do. You guys tell me. That's what I mean. Like, you guys know that I rely a lot on your feedback and suggestions.
Right,
you
know, and support.
So I'm 100% open to your suggestions of what I should do.
Really? I thought you had things under control, dude. That's what you told me yesterday.
Yeah, I know, Jay, this sucks. Don't you want? You just want to relax and watch games. And I hear you. Now we.
What is the?
This sucks.
So Jade says, what was this in relation to? I'm so confused. Because Jade says, I don't know. Watch this. See ya. I guess he's saying, I don't know if I want to watch this. Is it the Ghost of T?
Yeah. What would the suggestion?
Is it like that movie? What was that movie, dude? Where the ghost was in the electricity.
Questions B. Number one.
Ah, shit, I forgot it. With the kids in the house. It's like an 80s movie.
I'm open to that. You know? I'm not
Chat, help me.
Have them forever.
I need your support. Right?
But.
Need your feedback.
You know? I don't know.
What was that movie?
I literally
Poltergeist.
Don't
there you go. Thank you, Poltergeist.
ATT fiber optic. I don't.
There's a ghost.
In my area.
In the Wi-Fi.
Sadly, the only one that's fast here is.
Phil. Vandalee was better all along, Phil. Return the slab or suffer my curse.
No, see, you guys are in the past. So someone says,
you guys are in the past.
Data plan and do hotspot streaming. Number one, hotspot streaming is too slow.
It's such a futuristic stream where we're bending time and space.
For that. There's unlimited plans for phone data. That exists. Unlimited plans for phone data. But there's no unlimited plans for, what do you call it? There's no unlimited plans for the hotspots. They all do it on purpose. They cap them all. So you'll stream for a little
appearing
bit.
Offline.
Oh, hell yeah, yeah. He hasn't tried doing that yet. Appearing offline. Has he tried making a private stream?
You'll run out and...
Wi-Fi SSID, 5 gigahertz. Pandalee was hotter.
Yeah, Pandalee is always hotter, especially in 5G.
Then you end up paying exorbitant fees. I'll be paying thousands of dollars a month for internet. Okay, so that's not going to work.
Pandalee and 5G. Imagine that, dude. You got all the speed.
Mango, could you stop?
You got gigabit access.
Nonsense.
What did he say?
A keylogger with remote access installed on the mini PC, disguised as something else or hidden as a possibility, would give them access to his network.
Right, because that's connected right into the network. You know, no problem with that. And you don't even need to disguise it as anything. This is a guy who doesn't know how to do anything. You could have a keylogger.exe on the desktop. He's not even gonna fucking notice.
He's spamming the chat. You should contact the legal department here.
It's certainly, I guess, a possibility, but I don't know.
The situation is, I need to have my internet stop being messed with. Again, I have to explain. It's sad that I have to explain to people and talk to people like this, but I guess some people don't learn. All right, you ready? You ready for this?
You ready?
Okay.
Now he's going to talk down to his chat.
Legal action takes place once you have a situation that's happened and there's a legal action to put against it. So, for example, all right, let's say that within a week, either Comcast fixes the issue or doesn't, and I now have a week established that I couldn't work normally, right? And now we can say, okay, now you contact a lawyer, you contact the legal department, and you say, I lost a week of work because of this, and here's the damages, and here's all that, and you calculate all of that. You understand? You don't do that. You don't just run to the legal department and start screaming legal. That's not how life works. You can't. There's no lawsuit here. You understand? You think you know what you're talking about. You have no idea what you're talking about at all. So spamming my chat with that is just a waste of everyone's time. You know? Again, is it a good idea that long term, if this doesn't get resolved, and I lose?
Oh, he's dropping frames like crazy again.
Okay. Then yeah.
Oops. What happened?
Absolutely. Then you look into something like that. You don't run to a legal department now. Like, what are you talking about? Right? Anyway.
Anyway.
I'm going to probably have to do that. It sucks that I'm probably going to have to do that. I don't want to have to do that.
What is he going to do?
To like that, I'm probably going to have to do that. You're right. I do have to do research about other internet service providers. This morning is I absolutely like the quality of the internet. I do like the fact that, you know, they take stuff seriously usually, and they try to send people out here within reason when there's issues and stuff, right? So you know, but I don't want, you know, it just sucks. I don't know what else to do. Honestly.
Oops. Did he get leaned in again? Almost. Oh, we dodged the bullet this time.
Maybe drop them, unless this gets resolved.
Oops. Another one. Wait.
You know, unless they take it seriously.
Oh, just a light one. It wasn't a serious earthquake.
You know, maybe what I need to do is switch.
Yeah, you just need to get a job, dude.
There is a legal place that you can come.
Her joyful regional manager thinking face.
Yeah, we can harass the regional manager, but we can't talk to legal when money is being stolen from him.
I use data for hotspot £15 a month. It's okay.
Oh, hell yeah. I use, I'm on a prepaid that costs like less than 5 euros a month. And I just get data. That's all I need.
Contact.
I get a little bit of credit as well.
Here's the legal, whatchamacallit.
Whatchamacallit.
Right, here's the legal, we go to some page on Comcast and contact the legal email, right? See, I have this ticket number. I have the actual ticket number with fraud, right?
Oh man, this whole stream is fucking fraud, because he's lagging so much. Look at this, he's chopping up. You can't even get a smooth rocking back and forth. It always chops up. It's like 10 frames per second rocking. And now we got another F.
Would do something over me doing what I just did, right?
He's getting piped, big dick style. But then again, if the guy had access to his modem, didn't they have access to his actual IP? Therefore, they can do a lot more than actually just do whatever they're doing right now.
Mango, you did not give me a direct page with a direct email address.
Like, I'm really confused about this whole thing.
You can't even do that because you can't put a link into
it. All I know is that it's entertaining as fuck.
All right? Mango just freaking out because he spammed the chat a million times. And I couldn't even see it because my internet was going down a million times. He's all upset at me now. That's crazy. I could try to scroll up.
Oh, he is getting badder right now.
Page.
Wait, are we actually doing this right now? Oh my god. He's going to their site now to dispute it.
Let's look.
Are we gonna have a live... We have nothing better to do? What? Yo, you still haven't done the schedule. Come on, man. Everybody's excited for the schedule. What about DSP News? It was your favorite segment, my favorite segment. What happened to that? Nothing better to do. Aww. Now he's twirling his mustache like a villain. What if he's actually behind all of this? It's all orchestrated for pity. He has a pedal that he steps on and it makes him lag. It's literally a lag switch pedal. That's what he's doing right now. And he's been faking how stupid he is. So it's actually him that logged into his own control panel and changed his Wi-Fi name to Panda Lee Was Hotter. So Cat would feel insecure. No, therefore, Cat would be more secure in that household. See?
Where is it says this on best... your year's top 10? This might be number 1 right now for me.
Nah, that's it's a solid 2 for now.
Way to contact
solid
to
2.
Call the business line, which
considering
I
this is just the kickoff to the saga. This is not even like... It's not getting resolved now. This is just the opener. This is day 1.
That's what comes up in Google when I search for this. It doesn't have a website at all. If I scroll down...
Uh-huh.
There's guidance for law enforcement.
Number one is the interview, of course.
So that's not me.
Interview will always be number one unless he, I don't know, something like super extreme happens.
Notice
Christmas came early.
Yeah, man, it's the season. He's been saying it. I didn't trust him this whole time. It's the season, but it actually is the season.
Get in touch with Comcast specialist to assist you in resolving the issue. Click here, and it just brings you right to your regular customer support. If you're unable to resolve the issue, you can submit a notice of dispute to the legal department. We'll contact you in an effort to resolve your dispute within 60 days of your submission.
Wow, that's crazy. Days. But what I'm also supposed to believe is that at this moment, the guy who has access to his account also has the ability to make transactions from his bank account to Comcast. And DSP doesn't seem too worked up about that. So that's a food for thought, I guess. It's pretty interesting.
Submit a notice of dispute.
Oh my! But actually, my favorite thing about this is that somebody paid his bill for him, and he was fucking pissed off. How dare you pay my fucking bills?
My account's not with Xfinity. My account is with Comcast Business. It's completely different.
Yeah, I don't really care.
This whole thing, I guarantee you, it's gonna
just keep crying.
Put this in. And they're going to say, oh, you don't have an account with us. because I know for a fact that they keep doing that too, which is ridiculous. But like, for example,
another F. Oh my God, they're clapping his cheeks right now, man.
This could be just KDLING a bunch of games from Steam hogging the bandwidth.
Uh-huh.
Wi-Fi Peepuppy is probably King of Hate 82 and it got spoofed.
I don't know about that. I don't know. Is this definitely a very complex situation? But Kat, if she was downloading something, she would be on a different network because nobody is on the same network as Phil. He needs all the bandwidth to stream in silky smooth 1 million FPS. In 1 million bits per second. In 1 trillion resolution. Oh, he got clapped again. Let's refresh. Maybe he's back. No, he's not. He's still leaning. It's fantastic. Oh. So yeah, that Mango Jewel Pods guy, trying to help, but like, something that you learn about DSP with time is that you shouldn't give a fuck about helping him, because he takes help for granted, and most of the times he's just gonna deny it, not believing what you believe is true, and it's just like, simply not worth it. It's just not worth it. Fuck him. Let him take care of himself. That's his biggest problem ever, has been not even being able to take care of himself and just being used to everybody else taking care of him. And now something like this happens where he has to take care of it himself and he's completely fucking befuddled, bamboozled, and confused. And now we're just browsing somebody's support page while Dead Air plays, as his stream is just chopping up because somebody is allegedly fucking with him.
Can't check. All
I can't check now.
So I can't check online. Call now only.
Why don't you call?
Yeah.
Just call him on the air. Come on.
Call.
That's good content.
No way to check availability.
It's not like we have anything better to do.
Call today.
This stream's probably going to go for another like an hour to 2 hours, maybe even three.
Yeah, nothing here about checking online that I can see.
Sure.
Let me try this. There's different sites you can click.
Could be the employee just gave his info to someone else who is now DDoS him from somewhere else. Ironically, I do actually believe him here, and it's definitely wrong and I don't condone this stuff, but he had it coming. I want Phil to fail on his own.
I don't exactly know what to believe, but I believe some things. It's just like the overall narrative is too contrived for it all to be true. Some of it has to be just made up fabrication. Or it might be him just speculating and taking things as fact. Because you know how easy he tends to do that. You know how easy his confirmation bias kicks in. So yeah, I'm not going to jump on the bandwagon and call it all true, but I need to think about it, because there's definitely some things that really stink.
Call. The fiber stuff, you have to call AT&T.
And I do think the mini PC is still in play. Even though it's kind of less likely, but that would be a very interesting outcome. And of course, if he considers it, then he's going to be super paranoid about it.
All right, check availability. I'm going to click on here. Okay, I can put in my address.
All right. I love that we're getting this in real time, because that's the content that I show up for every day on DSP Gaming. A guy typing emails while Dead Air plays. And notice how this doesn't even have the podcast layout, because it's not supposed to be the podcast. Therefore, it is kind of accepted that he doesn't do the normal format. It would be pretty funny if he did a schedule segment too, though. It would be very funny.
Nope. So that's a no-go, which it was worth a shot, but that's a no-go.
Oh, wow. So Mango Jewel Pods for 18 months sends him this membership message. Last month as a member, everyone was right about you. That's the actual fucking message. How hot. Well, it took you a while, Mango fucking cuck.
No real feasible.
But he's going to be back this time next month, too.
To swap to. It seems like they're all kind of the same. The same thing.
Did he got leaned in? No, the message's still here.
I received a $5 tip. From Dan the Man. Thank you, Dan the Man, for a $5 tip. I appreciate that.
Oh, and we're playing the nice pop-ups, and everything is super Christmas-themed. Okay. Oh, it's such a wholesome stream.
Advanced payment, like paying 3 months ahead if you don't want to deal with bills month by month. You can do it once or twice a year.
Yeah, right, right, right.
I'm curious.
That's,
were any ever time
that's probably what it is.
Because I hit suspend.
What?
But I don't know if it worked or not because the internet...
is the weirdest shit.
Of himself. Are you mad? The entirety of civilization is required to keep Piggy alive, and you better be grateful for it. Damn it, as he expects you to.
You know, you're absolutely right, but at some point a grown-ass man should be able to take care of himself. At some point, maybe he should be 60 until that happens.
Like, you guys,
maybe 75
or not. Like, I have no idea, right?
I wonder what the genuine answer would be if somebody asked him, like, hey Phil, why can't you just be an independent, self-sustaining person,
right?
These are fucking trolls, dude. Every time I try and be one, like, they just fuck with me, you know? Big ups, victory for the sub.
You did get ads? Because I have them suspended.
And people lying to him now.
Maybe it's only when the stream goes up and down. As the stream goes up
this
and down.
This is so stupid.
Again, right? Maybe then it does it? I don't know. I did. I clicked, that's what I mean. Like, I clicked disable up here. It says disable, but I think what happens is because the internet's all screwed up. Like, all the stream things messed up. Let me try refreshing, maybe. I don't know. I've tried to disable them the whole stream, but maybe they're I don't know. You know. This whole thing's really screwed up today. Obviously. Nothing's working properly. I turned it off.
Oops, he got hit again. He got struck by a smooth Comcast criminal. Another time. How many times has this happened? Like 6-7 times already? It's pretty wild. Oh, man. Do we get to refresh or is he just going to repeat himself and start lagging? Oops, yep. That's what's going to happen. Oh, that Comcast guy. This shit sucks, dude. Ah. Is this gonna be the rest of the stream, though? That's my real question. He's just gonna start lagging every 20 seconds. It's just gonna be this. Pretty entertaining, I have to ask. More entertaining than him playing Call of Duty. What else? Any kind of Super Mario game, any kind of Sonic game, any kind of RPG. Yeah, so this is more entertaining than a bunch of his streams. But I guess the moral of the story really is don't make people on the internet fuck with you by telling them how unstoppable you are. That is the moral of the story for me. Especially if you're not unstoppable. Especially even if you're very stoppable. Because DSP, one of the most stoppable people ever. One of the most touchable people ever. So him trying to tell you that he's unstoppable, you can't touch him, you can't mess with him, he's going to leave on his own terms. Yeah, we saw how that worked out. Because right now, he's not here, and it's not his own choice.
I
I turned it off.
Yeah, it's just messed up. He's gone. He has been gone. He's been buffering. This is now the buffer stream. I don't know. What do we do instead? What do we do instead? Since there's nothing to do really here. Brunel?
I turned it off.
Oops, nope. The same thing. Oh, he's been... Oh, man. He's so fucking good. Should we rewind to a random point?
That they're supposed to be helping me. Why did they put me in a circle? Right? Like, he's mad. The actual billing agent is pissed that this person in fraud seems to be blowing me off and not helping me. Okay? So he's actually...
Okay, yeah, I'm not going for reruns of this, especially this early. Oh, I think he's back. I think he stopped lagging for a second then.
I turned it off.
But he dropped like a million people. Oh, yeah. There's now 400 people watching him. He used to have like 1K. Oh, he didn't even get to enjoy getting 1K, man. He didn't even get to enjoy that. It wasn't even a flex. He didn't even say, oh my god, there's like over 1,000 people watching. Well, too bad there's no gameplay, you guys. That's what he would have done. Like, oh my god, you guys should show up for my gameplay. You know, the actual content that you guys love. Sounds good. This is the refresh stream. You gotta love it. It's gonna be the same thing again, huh? Yep, he turned it off. Oh, you bet your ass he did. Do we have a community post, maybe? Do we? We could. That is a possibility. And we don't. We have the old community post and it has only 2 likes. So all those people that went to his stream, they should go and like the community post, man, for engagement purposes. Gonna get him back to prominence. Content like this is gonna shoot him to the moon. It's gonna be viral. He's gonna be the guy that destroyed Comcast. But there is probably a part of me that is low-key scared that he might destroy Comcast. It's like 1%. It's like in the back of my mind, the back of my head, and it's telling me, Phil is gonna destroy Comcast. He is gonna be the guy. He is him. Then he's gonna make like a $10 million. Imagine this. He wins $10 million from a lawsuit. At that point, I don't even know what the trolls are going to do. They can't even do anything. He's going to have so much money. He's going to make a safe room for himself in his house so nobody can ever touch him. He's going to be running like gigabit internet so he can stream in 50,000 kilobits per second. 50,000. Imagine that. One for every dollar that Keemstar offered him. Maybe even 100,000 kilobits per second. Imagine that. You would see him in like crispy, clear, like 1,000p. No, 1,000p is low. 10,000p. Gonna be crazy, dude. It's gonna be streaming in 16k. 16 times the graphics. 16 times the snorts. Imagine that. Imagine if his audio was buffed up to like studio quality.
Okay.
Oh, he's back. Is he?
Coming back now.
Yep, we are back.
Hello?
Hello?
Can you guys hear and see me now?
Yep.
Hopefully.
Sadly.
So.
He's going to be streaming like 600 FPS. When Jasper looks at the stream, he's going to get a seizure. Jasper's going to go crazy at the stream.
Could you do it so that day streams are like certain kinds of content? No, what Cyber says is, can I only stream at night? Well, then I'm only doing half as much work. I can't stream overnight. I have a sleep schedule. My family has a sleep schedule.
He has a sleep schedule.
I can't be streaming all night. I can't. I have to stop streaming it.
So, by the way, that's a suggestion. Why don't you stream when your detractor is not at work? That's actually the fucking... That's a new gimmick. He gotta be going around detractors just so he can stream. That's the state of Dave.
Can't make loud
the absolute state of Philip Burnell.
Stuff, people are gonna get pissed.
Right? He's gonna be hiding from the trolls, literally hiding. It has to be like so they're not at work, so they can fuck with him.
The weird thing is,
but he's gonna bother his sleeping schedule, and he died again. Man, he's getting fucking stabbed like a billion times. The autopsy of this is gonna be crazy. Oh, and another rip. Another rip. This is like the ninth time probably that happens. And this chat has been very fun. You know, some people just tuning in, super panicked. They don't know what's happening. Super confused. Other people like giving them weird suggestions. Hey, Phil, have you tried streaming at night when your detractor is sleeping? Because when he wakes up, man, he's going to be angry. He's going to take you down again.
Dollar alert.
Same age as Pig Side Beside, he would look like my dad.
Yeah, well, there we go. He does look, for 40, he looks really rough, man. He looks like he's been living off of cigarettes and stress for the last 20 years. But it's just gin and stress instead. It's not much different. Not much different. What's the possibility the perpetrator is in his chat? I don't know.
Now,
I mean, if we consider this story to be correct, there's any possibility of everything happening. He might get drone striked right now by like an Israeli drone or something. Who fucking knows?
The weird thing is.
What is the weird thing, Phil? Oops, I don't know. I wish he could tell it was the weird thing.
It has to be like daytime hours. Now, the weird thing is.
Ah, we couldn't get to the weird thing again. Come on, man, I'm here for the weird stuff. What happened with it? What's with it, Philip? I guess nothing. This is the nothing stream. He left you hanging. Now you have to speculate what the weird thing is. What is the weird thing, huh? That maybe the Comcast detractor, maybe he's gonna work the night shift so he can mess with DSP at night as well. Maybe there's multiple detractors that can cover every shift.
The lag switch god is the new DSP character.
Yeah, dude, the lag switch god. This god messing with him in real time. This is karma. This is just simply karma. There's nothing else. It's just life catching up. To the point where he can't even stream. He can't even go on Twitch right now. If he wanted to go on Twitch, he couldn't do it. Because he would be doing this again. And we would still have to figure out what the weird thing is. Oh, but somebody is smoking the DSP pack. That is 100%. I don't know if it's a Comcast guy.
If he chose option 3, and as soon as he was Rainbow's Minecrafted, Keem started a live stream and milked it and made thousands off of it. Too bad perfect endings don't exist.
Yeah, this is not going to be a perfect ending, but it's going to be like, I guess, somewhat acceptable. Unless he wins the lawsuit against Comcast, if there was one. Then he would be balling. That's the worst outcome, is he beats Comcast. He's like destroying him.
We may never have gotten the Lolco podcast if the Comcast detractor didn't switch Phil off during the interview. The butterfly effect is crazy here.
Well, that's what he wants you to believe. Which I guess there is some possibility that was the mystery detractor that switched him off. But that didn't mean that Keemstar wouldn't have joined, because he agreed to Keemstar joining the call.
I believe that his modem is compromised, but like with the bank leaks, I don't believe money was taken. He always says money is involved and he never provided proof.
That is a fair assessment. That is a fair guess. I give you that. I got nothing against that. Because we didn't really see anything with the money being involved. Maybe there was some sensitive info he couldn't show, but I don't know, man. I don't know. But right now, I am enjoying this stream. It's probably some of the best content I've seen so far, especially these buffering streams, because it gives me a break.
It has to be like daytime hours. Now, the weird thing is...
Oh, we couldn't find the weird thing again. We got edged. But people are still in his chat. They're more active than ever, even.
Also, these internet dropouts are awfully coincidental.
Well, especially during this stream. Right now, somebody is just actively just... piping him.
Stop, please. We are watching the stream rolling on the floor laughing.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm talking over Phil too much. I'm sorry. I didn't get the... That's why we missed what the interesting thing was. What the weird thing was. I still don't know, dude. Because I talked over it. God damn it. Now when the buffer comes back, we get to find out, actually. And now he has the normal amount of views. He got like 300 people watching because, I mean, there's literally nothing to watch. Like, what do you mean? What do you actually mean? But his chat is interesting. Good thing 1 Minute Man showed up. Phil should not rest on his laurels on this one. People aren't donating enough. Oh yeah, this guy is asking himself to get banned. What the fuck is this? People aren't donating enough. How dare you? Phil is here putting the quality content. He's doing everything for you guys. He's entertaining. He's about to tell you what the weird thing is. I think. Hopefully. We might get swerved, though. He might never just come back. Yeah. He's gonna change his ISP and keep paying for Comcast. That's what I think is gonna happen. We got a panic change in the ISP. Oh, is he back? Let's refresh.
It has to be like daytime hours. Now, the weird thing is...
Oh, you're getting timed out for this troll, Kyle Denson. You're getting timed out. Nobody can lie to me on my stream. I don't want dishonest people on my streams that tell me that DSP is back while he's not back. You liar.
Ain't nobody gonna tell me.
When DSP is back. There we go. He really is edging us. He really is giving us all this edge. This is the edgiest he's been. What do we have here? People keep going in his chat, though. This is the most active it's ever been. Just got here. Oh, yo, we're back.
A lawsuit is a win for Scopely in the end.
Oh, yeah. Scopely gets the... This is my they get the best.
Part of the Spectrum Services area.
Oh, there we go.
But it's looking for
other providers. But this is old news now.
It went to Xfinity.
Super delayed.
It went to Xfinity. Oh my god. That's great.
Hold on, I need to actually refresh one more time. This time is going to work, you guys, I promise.
So, two things, guys, because it's coming back briefly. I searched for AT&T Fiber, not available in my area. I just searched for Spectrum Internet. That's also not available in my area, but it says we found a partner, and it sent me to Xfinity, which is Comcast.
Meh.
So those are out.
He's suffering from success, guys.
Solutions or not.
Well, he's suffering from something, but I'm not sure if that's what you call success, unless they change the definition of what delusion is.
It seem like in my area, there's many or any viable competitive solutions to Comcast, and that's kind of the problem. It's exactly like when I lived in Connecticut, where there just aren't really any real competitive providers, okay? Now, also, I'm trying to say things fast, just in case it goes down again, which it likely will. Cypress had an idea, said, well, can you adjust your streaming schedule to later at night? And the answer is no. I have a normal life schedule. We sleep. My wife has to sleep to work.
What does your wife has to do with... What? My cat is used to sleep at certain times? Really? Really? Jasper is a problem in this case? That his... Bruh.
So I'm working all night.
And my wife has to sleep. But what the fuck does she have to do with any of this?
Plus, I can't be screaming at night. I have neighbors and stuff. You see?
Oh my... You don't have to be screaming.
What I'm thinking of doing...
Just streaming.
For day stream.
My cat sleeps, you guys. I can't stream.
More... of
the most dependent guy on the internet.
So anything that's like story based, so there's no online play to be interrupted when the internet's going down. And all the night streams would be multiplayer. But I don't know viably.
Oops, and we got a lip licking buffering segment. Ah, come on, not again. And they had to pause us on a lip lick. This troll, man. He calculated everything perfectly. And now we're on a lip lick. We can't even escape this. Let me see what's going to happen if I refresh.
Multiplayer, but I don't know.
Oh, this time we paused earlier. That's all right. I'm cool with that. Just not the lip lick. We do not need that. And? Are we back? Perhaps? And, oh yeah, now somebody is bringing up in chat Mango getting his apology. So apparently that's now a narrative that DSP should apologize to Mango Jewel Pods, whatever the fuck that cuck was. Which, sure. I'm all for DSP apologizing to anybody. You got a lot of people to apologize to. And now we're frozen on the lip lick again. I cannot believe my eyes. I see this and I cannot believe. Is this Phil? How has Phil become this? I used to show up for high quality let's plays, commentary, gaming news, and now we just got buffering and lip licking. How the mighty have fallen. Oh, I think I'm gonna cancel my membership to DSP Reacts. I was an Ultimate member because I want him to watch all my videos about Singaporean food in vending machines. In all my videos, they never had any women in them, so they were perfectly watchable. Come on, man, why you gotta do this to me, Phil? I've been a fan since like 2001. When 9/11 happened, I needed to cope with it. I was really hurt. I discovered Phil. He hasn't even started making content yet, but I discovered him before it was even cool. I watched his Heavy Rain playthrough. I enjoyed the song. That song, man. That song. It's a landmark achievement in music. The rain is very heavy. Heavy is the rain. He's legitimately still fucking gone. Come on, man. Fix your internet. Go on, like, mobile data or something. Come on, just come back online. Because what the fuck is this? Oh, yeah, now the detractors can't easily clip him and post it. That is a good point. What if it was all for this? He's making his streams unwatchable on purpose. Oh, think about that. It's all on purpose. Now you can't hate on him if you don't get to watch his stream. You can't restream him if you're just gonna sit here and look at him licking his lips and the screen buffers. You can't post a clip while he's still live because you don't even know what he's about to say. It's pretty crazy, you know? He took the next step in destroying the trolls by destroying his own content. And it's paid off. Look at this. 1 minute, man, instead of giving him a 20, he gave him an 100. And he left a message. I'm tasting the success already. This is the first step to a whole new generation of DSP content where there's not even going to be any content. The content is that there's no content and everything is pre-recorded. I wonder what he's doing right now. I would really like to find out. Because the internet could be back and he could just be gone somewhere. Yeah, 1 minute man gave him 100 apparently. Because it's a big deal. Of course it's a big deal. It's a stream that has emergency in the title. All caps. Of course it's a big deal. It's a huge deal, I would even say. Massive.
It's going on and off so much. So it's probably not going to work.
And it came back for a second, but now we're gone again. I don't know, man. I would give this stream a 5 out of 6 stars. And the one star that's missing is because there is no stream right now. If there was a stream, I would give it 6 stars. 10 out of 10. Instant classic. At least the people watching this on demand are going to have a fun time. They don't have to actually sit through the buffering stuff.
Internet's going on and off so much.
Yep, I can tell.
So it's probably not going to work.
Do we have a community post, maybe? Maybe he's going to cancel this stream? That's what I would do. If nobody can actually watch your stream, you should probably not have a stream. Or maybe he's going to do what Acid Phase did and just have a choppy-ass stream where he's buffering every 20 seconds, but pretend like there's nothing wrong and just do his thing. I wish he would do that and just play video games and buffer every 20 seconds. Oh, he's still making bank off this whole thing? Of course he would. It's the emergency economy. He makes bank every time there's an emergency. But he needs emergencies to keep going because otherwise his business is not sustainable. So it is absolutely to be expected that he would make some good shit out of this.
Internet's going on.
It's just the emergency lifestyle. You can even call it a lifestyle. His whole gimmick is like hoping that something bad's gonna happen so he can make money off of it and then just be a victim. Because it's super easy for him to be a victim. And especially people that are not self-sustainable, their whole gimmick is to be a victim because it's really fucking easy. It's really easy, as you can see.
Internet's going on and off so much.
Yep, I could tell. But yeah, you do have a point, Innocent Orphan. These kind of emergency streams did get him way more money in the past. He was making like easy $200 to $300 just out of nowhere, just like that. Especially on the marathons. The marathons were so much more profitable. He could be getting like over $300 just casually. But nowadays, the well has gotten dry, man. It's not doing great for him. So apparently he is in chat claiming to do something that's going to fix this. So he said testing. And then he says, okay, so I'm doing something differently to at least chat. We're going to see what's happening. Okay, I'm going to try to stream again in a few minutes. I need a quick bathroom break regardless. He just went to the bathroom like 20 minutes ago. Half an hour ago, he went to the bathroom. Like, bro, what? What? Been drinking some hardcore seltzer. More bathroom breaks. And there's not even a stream on. It's not even music. Like, what is he even actually hoping to do? Is this going to go for another 3.5 hours? 2.5 hours, excuse me. Because he's supposed to go until 2 a.m. my time. And now it's 11:30 my time. So we got half an hour to 12 and then 2 more hours. So 2.5 hours if he wants to go by schedule, which is absolutely insane. I wouldn't do that because you literally can't watch his stream. I mean, of course. And the guy is getting him fucked right now. Absolutely destroying him. I guess he's going all out. Or maybe he has some insurance policy, so he's not going to get fired or something. I don't know. There's too many variables at play with this storyline. This is the very tangled, complicated, messed up storyline. But the one thing I know is that those screenshots from the control panel were hilarious. And I'm going to show them to you right now. Absolutely fucking outstanding screenshots. This shit is iconic. Panda Lee was hotter. And then Greedy Piggy. That's how he changed his Wi-Fi username. Not username, no, the network name. Absolutely fucking hilarious. Greedy Piggy. And they tried to block certain words for some reason. They tried to block access to PayPal, YouTube, and Twitter, which I guess is kind of doing DSP a favor then, but I don't know. I could see why he would be upset. And they tried to block the words, I think, DSP Gaming and Phil. It's super weird that they would do that, but they did that? I am very confused. I'm struck by a terminal case of confusion. But I'm sure people are going to pick apart this segment and take out everything that's worth taking out and summarizing it in a way that's at least semi-digestible. Would I risk my job to troll Phil? No. But somebody else did, and I think that's absolutely hilarious. I hope they take care of their privacy so they don't get screwed up, but you never really know. Maybe they're just a fucking stupid idiot detractor. But it seems to me like somebody's actually trying to fuck with him. Because the times in which his stream goes buffering is very convenient. I don't think it's an inside job. I think it is. I mean, I don't think it's him doing it. That's the one thing I'm 90%. 90%. That's a lot of percentage. But there's still the 10% that something else might be happening. Because with this dude, You literally never know. Some crazy shit can happen. Hey, what's up, everybody? Coming from the brand dude stream. We have an update here. I don't know what you guys been doing, but here we've been looking at this totally active and working DSP stream that is currently buffering, but don't be concerned. Don't worry about it. No problem. We're going to be back anytime now. We're working on it. Everybody at Comcast working hard. They got their A team on the case. They're going to take care of it. They're going to take down that detractor, send him to federal penitentiary. They're going to send him to Guantanamo Bay. They're going to send him somewhere to a black site in the Middle East. They're going to torture him. And everything's going to be good in the end. Yeah, they got the Sway team. The Sway team is on the case. And they're not going to have a moment of break, not even a bathroom break, until they take care of the problem. Because, you know, this is what Phil deserves. Because he pays for that preferential business treatment. I guess this is the business treatment, is having your business be taken down. That's the good kind of treatment. And he's still gone. Like, what the fuck is happening with him? Not even, like, an update. And he's given shout outs in chat. Look at this. By the way, should out. That's not even a shout. It's a should. Should out to Fever Our Dreams, who tipped. I tried shouting out 3 times, but obviously it's not working. That's fucking great, dude. He's sitting around giving actual shout outs in chat. Is this the future of DSP streams? Is just not even a stream going on, but giving text, like actual text, text shout outs in chat. Well, I mean, good. If somebody's willing to pay for it, then fair enough. Fair enough. Shootout. Shootout 1 minute ban, okay? I wonder what the Turkey Tom response video is, but that one is too long for me to start watching it now, because this dude can come back anytime, you guys, and he might have a development on the case. That wouldn't be crazy, would it? Wow, if he had a development and they fixed the issue and the guy who did it is now on his way to jail. And now, not only did they fix it, but they're going to give him free internet for the next 20 years. All you can eat internet. That's awesome. Imagine if that happened. Or maybe there's going to be more detractors at Comcast. Maybe it's going to get worse. You're going to start taking down his phone internet. You're going to start taking down the cat internet so cat can download mods for Skyrim on her Xbox. Man, that's going to be a disaster. Hopefully that doesn't happen. I hope Phil is on the case and he takes care of it. Because he told me yesterday he was going to take care of it. Right? He said everything's under control. He's done measures to take care of it. He bought a new modem. You know, a brand new modem. I hope it was a gaming modem because the gaming modems are much better than the normal ones. Because they cost more and they look cool. You know, they look like... like some crazy creature. Some of them look like a spider. They got all these antennas. They can get better reception when you play mobile games. So, yeah, there's people in his chat trying to provoke Comcast, saying that everyone... well, it's not people in his chat. It's just one guy. Everyone, spam Comcast and tell him an employee of theirs is committing fraud and other charges against Phil as a customer. That's what we should all do. Guys... go to Comcast right now. Go to Comcast headquarters and protest right in front of it and tell them that Phil sent you. Right? Please do that. Please. Go there physically in real life. I'm joking, of course. I kind of have to say this for YouTube. For YouTube. Don't do anything. Don't go anywhere. Stay here. Stay here and watch this stream right now, because Phil can come back any minute with a breaking development in the case. This might be like one of those live courtroom segments, like when Johnny Depp and Amber Turd did their thing. Yeah, we should have a free DSP. Hashtag free DSP. That's what we get. Get my boy Phil free, because he's being held hostage by trolls working for Comcast. Imagine telling somebody this. They're gonna think you're fucking schizophrenic or something. My friend Phil, he's been taken hostage. They wouldn't let him go. We don't even know what their demands are. Imagine if they came back with their demands. What would they demand? Screenshots of the champion's account? And they're gonna give him his internet back. This is so fucking funny, man. Somebody stole his internet and is keeping him hostage right now. And little Phil, he got nothing to do. He's like literally completely helpless. Completely helpless. Nobody he can call. Nobody in chat is helping him. Because of course they won't. It's fucking DSP's chat. They don't know anything. He's sitting there. He's trying to do his best, you know. Maybe he's back. Let's refresh again.
Internet's going on and off, on and off.
Oh no, he's not back. How am I this stupid thinking that his internet is back? Come on. Not like he's like a professional or something with a business class internet. And of course, to put things in perspective, he pays around $400 for this service. It's actually crazy. Because I'm on fiber, and it's not the best speeds. It's like 90 megabits per second, upload, download. I'm really cool with it because I pay 15 euros per month for that. Fiber optic, good stuff. And I kind of live a little bit off the grid. I'm not in a major metropolitan type of area. So yeah, I guess you get what you pay for. That's what you get. Yeah. Well, at least my stream got zero drop frames, and his stream got all the drop frames. All the drop frames in the world are happening right now in real time on DSP Gaming. It's a phenomenon. It's like when they do a concert in Fortnite. Everybody tunes in and watches it. Dude, we got Travis Scott in Fortnite. And for the first time ever, nobody can possibly die in his concert. It's awesome. I should go there. And that's what we're doing here. We're waiting for a loading screen to pass. Yep, we're still here. But people keep sending super chats, so I guess it's working. Everyone spam Comcast an employee messing with Phil. Yeah, thank you, Lil Shake and Bake. I'm definitely gonna do that. That's I'm on my way to Comcast right now. I'm actually in the car. Actually, I'm in the plane. And then I have a car to get. I like this message by the House of Knights that simply says LOL. But I couldn't if there is one word. Well, that's not really a word. That encapsulates this whole stream is LOL. An abbreviation, if you would. This is actually wild.
Internet's going on and off so much.
Yeah, really. I agree with you, Tyrone. It couldn't have happened to a nicer guy. Phil is such a nice guy. I wish nothing like this ever happens to him again. Unless it happens to him. Always, which I wouldn't mind. Oh, and we got no updates whatsoever. No updates. What was he supposed to do today? It's Tuesday, right? Super Mario RPG. We're supposed to be playing Super Mario right now. What happened with that? Where is Mario? And then he's supposed to play Street Fighter 6 on the night stream. And he's gonna do the night stream because then the detractor is gonna be sleeping. Yeah, because now his whole schedule is based around this one abstract entity schedule that we don't even know if he is or isn't an employee of Comcast. The details are still kind of shady. Is he wearing a hat right now? No, we didn't even get a hat poll. How dare you, Phil? You scammed everybody out of a hat. I was expecting to get it. I was expecting that hat, man. He almost got to 150. That's unfair. We're getting scammed right now. Imagine if he was crying and buffering in a Sonic hat. That would make everything so much better. Phil in a Sonic hat right now. That would be some hot fucking content. Hot. Yeah, you don't understand why DSP can't make videos like he used to and just upload VODs? Why does he have to stream? Because he would make absolutely nothing on ad revenue. You look at the views he gets. He has like a couple hundred views per video. This is terrible. 13 hours ago, he put up a Call of Duty video that got like 300 views. I don't know what the CPM for that is, but he's not gonna make, quote-unquote, anything on this. So no, that's absolutely not viable. This channel, as a videos-on-demand kind of a channel, is completely washed. It completely doesn't exist. It's actually worthless. Yeah, I would see your point if he would get super thanks on the videos, but I don't think that's very likely. Plus, YouTube takes a cut. The thing that he needs is the tips. Him without tips, he can't exist. It's not a reality that is viable. He actually can't do it. Actually.
Internet's going on and off so much.
And he's still gone. Probably not going to work. Oh, it's nice to give him a vibe check every once in a while. What do we got? While he's gone, let me just pull this in a separate tab, because I'm not going to be sitting here watching him endlessly. I think what we got so far was enough. So as he said in his daily wrap yesterday, he's doing something against it. Let's see the comments here. So, we got a summary here for some reason. So basically, Phil encountered unexpected internet issues during his Monday stream, disrupting his plans for Modern Warfare 3 gameplay. Thank you, ChatGPT. The interruptions led to a frustrating day, with only a partial stream completed. Phil suspects a potential malicious attack, taking steps to resolve the issue and prevent further disruptions. Despite technical challenges, he remains optimistic about returning to a normal streaming schedule and requests support for upcoming streams. Phil plans to share more details once the situation is fully resolved, emphasizing a desire for drama-free content. Thank you, Mr. Bot, for the summary of this bullshit. So now I didn't have to sit through 9 minutes of this, even though I did. Let's see, he's back? according to Death Monkey Butts. And he's a liar. So you're getting timed out as well. You're getting timed, buddy. You're getting killed. There are no... what was it? I don't want any... How did he put it? Insincere? How was that thing? God damn it, what was it fucking called? I don't want any insincere people in my chat. Is that what he said? There was a different word for it, for insincere. Dishonest, yes. I don't want dishonest people in my chat. That's what he fucking said. I relate to that. I don't want any dishonest people. Okay, yeah. So now apparently, according to him, he is back. I'm back and I'm going to talk with you guys. And I'm recording for upload, but I think this person just keeps resetting the internet. So trying to stream likely won't work. I will try from time to time, but please do talk with me as we are brainstorming. Do talk with me as my internet keeps going on and off for 10 minutes. And he's still not back. But it is time for brainstorming. At least we know what time it is. Unfortunately, Jade has tuned out. He has tuned out now, so there we go. Not happening. I'll try and timestamp this segment so the people on demand can just skip through it. Oh, that's a good question. What do you guys in chat think? Is this or the end of the vest streak better to watch live or more exciting? I wasn't there for the end of the vest streak, but it sounds like a very hype time. Because, you know, vest streak, 276 streams, that's a shit ton of time. But this, very explosive. The claims that he is making in this video is actually, like, outrageous. Somebody working for Comcast, fucking with him, on purpose, tweaking his network settings. He shows, quote-unquote, proof. He says there are two satellite internet, but one is apparently very slow.
Still working with OIC to throttle sympathy bucks.
Okay, that's a 4D strategy that... DSP is too fucking stupid for this shit. He's too stupid for 3D, 4D strategies. He doesn't even think life is in 3D. Like, that's a really cool clip of him. I might pull it up if I get the chance. Yeah, legitimately doesn't think that life, like real life, is in 3D. Let me just find it real quick. Because it's a really good fucking clip. Yeah, I got it here. I got it right here. Listen to this shit.
That real life really isn't that much 3D. Like, if someone throws a softball at you, do you really see this thing coming at you? Like, no, you see a 2D thing, you get hit in the fucking
anyway
face.
This story can be real. I say 90% no chance.
I don't know, man. There's a lot of things that are weird, and I'm making my opinion on it live, so I don't know. I'm not entirely certain, but there's a lot of stuff that I believe and some stuff that really stinks. Very particular fishy smell. It's like cat made a tuna casserole. That's what it smells like. That's what it smells like. I gotta be honest with you. But he's still glitching out. I don't know what happened with him. Did he figure it out? So he keeps talking to people in chat, but there's no actual stream to be watched. He's replying to BattleDuck9000. I don't even know what he said. I'd be getting the business plan. Not sure how different that is. I was looking it up, but I didn't see specifics. Said I should do a consultation. Oh, he's fucked. He's fucked. This whole week is going to be conquered by this situation. This is a magnitude of like 8.5 earthquake in Renton right now. It's actually crazy. Am I buffering a lot on my end? No. I got 0.0% drop frames today. Everything is absolutely silky smooth on my end. Because I got that cheap fiber optic. And he got that business shit that gets you hacked and people fuck with you. So yeah, you should definitely get whatever he's having. Because it seems super fun. I'm not doing 60 FPS though. Because nothing that I'm really watching on stream is 60 FPS. So there's not really any kind of point. The curls and twirls Google reviews. That's a pretty good detour. We can do that while he's gone. Why not? Curls and twirls. Renton, right? That should be Renton. Oh no, it's called Covington, Washington. I think that's it. Oh, but dude, you guys gotta see this. Hold on. Let me just make this searchable. God damn it, this shit's fucking stupid. Just one second. All right, so we got Curls and Twirls, Covington, Washington, right? And then we got a Reddit post. Curls and Twirls, Renton, Washington, did this atrocity. And this is an r/fuck just fuck my shit up. And this is a post about fucking Phil, if you can't tell. A little post about DSP. And it says, Curls and Twirls of Renton, Washington, did this atrocity to this man. $60 for this haircut, by the way. And they gave him the Adolf, the Adolf cut. The Final Solution type cut. Oh, man. And this apparently has like 15 replies on the r/justfuckmyshitup, which is a subreddit dedicated to jacked up haircuts from all walks of life, which this is one if I've ever seen it. I've ever seen it. Yeah, they gave him the Final Solution fade. That's what he got. My God. That's what they gave him. They solved everything. And then we got, it closes soon, apparently. So we got the Google reviews. Let's hit those up. I'm here to support Dave Snort. He needs that money to pay his bills, Snort. But if I need a haircut, I know where I'm going now, dudes. If they can make Dave look less subhuman, then forget the hat goal. Ack, ack, ack. That's a good fucking review. And it's also a 5-star review. So shout out to Anthony Campione for doing it. Because, you know, you're boosting their ratings. Then we got Fantastic Establishment. My neighbor got the quote-unquote mature adult cut, which took roughly 4 hours, including applying hair fiber spray. And by the time he came back, me and his wife had fixed the issues which plagued the kitchen sink and washing machine. And in brackets, we got, she got stuck for a few hours. This is a hot fucking review. This is a really hot review. Is the guy back, though? Let's give him a quick vibe check, just so we don't miss all the hot content that is not happening. Nope, he's fucking gone. He's completely wasted, man. Then we get... okay, this is a real one. This is a real one. This is a real one. Very disappointing. It's a real one. But shout out to Charissa, who is apparently the person giving the cuts. It's a pretty weird spelling, but, you know, you don't get to pick how you called. Then we get, Curls and Twirls was such a positive and chill experience. They did everything correct. And this has 51 upvotes. God damn it. Of course we got the iconic fucking Dave cut. Oh my God, look at this, bro. God damn it, this is the tree of life right here. What else do we have? Oh, that's it. But I bet if I look up Total Wine, we're gonna get a hit. Total Wine Renton. Right. Okay. We got. Oh wow. We have a lot of reviews for this. Like 1,600 reviews. And this is this for that? Oh yeah. This is for Tukwila, Washington. So that's the one. That is the guy. I just need to find the guy related reviews because people seem to be enjoying that store a lot. They're leaving so many reviews. There don't seem to be a lot of guy related material here. Very interesting. Unless there was ones that were posted without a photo. But what should I look up? What is a... Oh yeah, Burnell Productions. How could I forgot? Burnell Productions. Iconic. Yeah, DSP meanwhile is in chat. He says, I cannot stream from my phone because my hotspot internet is incredibly limited. The plan runs out after so little data. But I will try to stream again periodically. I'll just wait a bit and chat with you here in the meantime. What do you mean in chat? Like, is this actually what he thinks he wants to do? Actually? I'm just gonna be chilling here, you know, chatting with you guys in my stream chat of my stream that actually doesn't work. And that's what we're gonna do. That sounds good. So let's look up Burnell Style Productions. Ranton, of course. Oh, man. We got chamberofcommerce.com. We got everybody is fucking hype about Burnout Productions. We got chamberofcommerce.com. We got change.org. Rename Ranton, Washington to Snortville in honor of DSP. What? Oh, it only has 17 signatures, and it was started by Dick Stroke and Phil Vlogs. I would suggest everybody do this. I think this is something that is going to help everybody all around the globe, especially people living in Renton, Washington. Because, let's be honest, who else of any kind of importance has ever lived in Renton, Washington? No, any rock stars? Any kind of Nobel Prize winners? Any Hollywood sensations? No, I think not. I think it's just Phil. Phil is the only relevant person to ever come out of Renton, Washington. But let's see how Dick Stroke and Phil Vlogs is going to convince us to sign this petition. For years, Renton, Washington has existed as a small suburb of Seattle, housing one of the greatest pioneers of the video game content creation community, Phil Burnell. Phil Burnell, aka DSP Gaming, rose to power as the highest-ranked U.S. player of Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo, and from then has enraptured fans with his quick wit, casual racism, hair loss, as well as masturbating on camera. Oops, the camera's on? He pioneered YouTube Let's Plays. Is it fair that Markiplier and PewDiePie have millions of subs, and Phil has a measly 200k, even though he created the genre? No! I now believe it is time to globally recognize such a tour de force of the YouTube market by renaming the town Snortville in honor of Phil's constant snorting. Post-nasal drip. Nothing you can do about it. Please share the word, and hopefully we can convince Renton to be renamed in honor of our hero, Phil Burnell. Honestly, I've never been more touched than a speech like this, except when Pastor Eric Miller touched me, but that was a different type of touching. He knows he can touch me anytime he feels like it. Matter of fact, he might be touching me right now. So anyways, I am very convinced. And of course, in the bottom, we got the signature Richard Stroke and Phil Vlogs Esquire. Of course, we got to do it the professional way. What else do we get? Let's give him a quick vibe check. Yeah, he's in chat, and this shit is fucking stupid. I'm not going to do a play-by-play on him being in chat. Go fuck yourself. What do we got? Yeah, we got the reviews. We got 69 Google reviews. Oh, you know that's going to be good. So we got, first of all, we got A Day Ago by DW. I tried to deliver DoorDash to this business, but the instructions to get into the gated community were nonsensical. I called the business, and he refused.
I'm fishing $4 in chat, not call Comcast.
Well, oh yeah, that's what he's doing. He's not even going to try and call Comcast. He's just going to sit there, fish for dollars. Anyways, let's go back to the dramatic reading of the reviews. I called the business and he refused to answer the phone, opting instead to spam a mile-long dribble through the texting system on the app. I dumped the food at the nearest address. This jerk didn't even bother to tip, and he's making me run all over Hell's Half Acre. Okay? I find out later this guy is a streamer, and he says on a YouTube video that he set aside an entire day to stay home while his wife was shopping. But after he ordered food, now he's too busy to make a phone call? Then proceeds to claim, I don't speak English. Answer your phone, you idiot. P.S. I've gotten a few more orders from you. I snag them while I can. Do you enjoy my tang? I bet you do. And then we got this one. Oh my god, from the first sentence, I'm already on the floor. One of the best gambling rehab charities I've seen. The owner, who makes chill and positive content to encourage donations, is a nice enough man. He kindly asks for donations without seeming like he's pressuring you, and is very grateful. Sorry to hear about his gout, though. Oh, good stuff, man. Good stuff. Next up we have, upon entering the business establishment, I was hit with a gust of an untreated horse stable. Being a mature adult in 15 years of sitting on a chair, I walked to the back, stepping on DoorDash bags, to the curated content room where the owner was down from the rafters. You know what I'm saying, right? Then we got another one. This one is the Penetrator from 3 weeks ago. I've been frequenting this quality family-owned establishment for the last 15 years, and I always leave satisfied from their robust, meaningful content, dude. They even have some of the cleanest stables for when you ride in on your horse. Would tip again. Another satisfied customer. That's what I'm talking about, man. You might look at this stream and be like, what the fuck is going on? There's not even a stream happening. But actually, this is the content. And as you can see here, people are very happy with it. We got 3 back-to-back 5-star reviews. That's a pattern of success, if you ask me. That's a legacy of success. But now we have a 1-star review that is very long-winded. I'm getting concerned about it. So this is going to be a story. We got this one from Toilet Bread. And he says, oh, the owner tried to sell me a glance declawed cat once for $2,000. I immediately refused. And the owner said if I gave him $100, he'd take a shot of our finest whale tail gin. When I told him that this is a ridiculous scam, he snapped at me. He was incredibly rude and told me I was a mouth-drooling idiot who has no power over everyone, and to get fucked, whatever that means. I assume it was Italian, as the greasy, jowled owner claimed to be robust Mediterranean style. I was furious. I drove to confront him face to face. I had to wait for a very long time, due to the owner allowing himself 1 day a week to walk a horse around town. When I finally confronted him in real life, he laid on the ground in a fetal position, started crying, and told me that that was his depression. Also, he's an alcoholic. I gave up at that point. He was too pathetic. Anyways, this isn't really a business. It is a money laundering scheme for a company called Scopely. They run a mobile casino that takes money from mentally ill people and funnels them into a match 3 gacha game. Quite ingenious, but still a scam. I think it's safe to say, even though there are some mouth-drooling, fake, bought idiots, this is a very successful business. As you can see from an 1.8 out of 5 star rating. And as you can see here, people often mention, when it comes to Burnell Productions, they often mention horse, tip, owner, begging, deliver, game, costs, cat, crying, and hat. So if you're an enthusiast in any of those fields, you know, you can always rely on Burnell Productions to come through with quality on demand and meaningful, robust content. And I think when it comes to meaningful, robust content, I think that we kind of ran out of it right here. Because I don't think I'm that stupid to sit here and refresh in the hopes of him coming back so he can cry about not having internet. So I'm just going to end my stream right now. I'm going to check out who else is going live. So if you want to continue this journey into the land of buffering, you can actually do that. But until then, thanks everybody. Make sure to, do whatever you want in your life and have fun. And don't get Comcast. Because Comcast sucks balls, apparently. But now I'm going to forward you to Anthony Leadiston. Apparently, I just doxed his name. And he's going to tell you why this content is truly meaningful in ways that few other people can. And I hope you enjoy it. I'm going to see you there. Until next time, my children, much love.
Hey, you social media trolls, y'all can suck on these nuts. That's what's up.
We'll be home.